didn't work. I mean, it didn't work. I have to select my sunflower flowering. Now it's working. We're all good. Okay, and I'll get my live stream set up a little better, and we're just about ready to start the video. Nope, we had a little glitch there. I have to reshare the live stream or the video.
I'm gonna rewind that too.
There are people listening from every corner of this planet. No knowledge has been dispersed so beautifully, so balanced across the planet, on this planet ever. Maybe in the universe. You have the full potential of achieving everything in the universe. There is no need and there is no reason for man not to achieve. So, wherever you are, the way I taught you to make the coils double pole inside, you have continuous eco-gravitational magnetic field, and if you put CO2 on it, and you put zinc on it, you have connected the emotion of the man to it on a stable condition, and you'll find out you become a very peaceful man. Here, instead of having galaxies and universes and creating connection magnetically, we have used the matter state gravitational magnetic field strength to dominate and dictate the shape of the plasma. The nanotechnology, the nanomaterial which you have collectively developed in different ways by caustic, by electric currents, by whatever, fire or whatever, has that advantage that the matter, the nano and the plasma is all the same. So connection is very solid, it's very strong. The power of the plasma technology, the way we have thought, is beyond imagination of the man. Now you can create and control the plasma, which is the mother of the creation of the universe. You are given the seed of the essence of the creation. The foundation does not belong to no one and is not made of one anymore. You are developing it, you are structuring it, and from today, we will be still the same. We'll still develop the technology in different names, in different colors, in different nationalities, which they do not exist. It is beautiful when we see the Christian, the Muslims, the Jews, and every other belief are working together to build up systems. We have already become one faith. We already have become one nation, and we already become one planet. You got to remember one thing. Dates is irrelevant. Today is the last day of the Christian calendar, or tomorrow is the beginning of another. One day is connected to another. we don't stop. We are working round the clock. The Keshe Foundation team is working irrespective of time, position, religion, country. And now we achieve what we set out for.
Would you like to be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology? The Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute is now taking applications for the Man-Originated Zone Habitation and Nutrition Training Program, or MOJAN. The goal of MOJAN is to teach trainees how to create and utilize the magnetically oriented joint habitation and nutrition system that will be used for life in space. Be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology. The three-month MOJAN training program begins in the fall of 2016. Apply today at mojan.kfssi.org. Trainees will be taught every aspect of plasma technology needed for them to go to space and survive, and will be educated in space ethos. Participants are expected to bring the knowledge forward to the peoples of their nations to prepare them to become peoples of space. Matter propulsion technology. To date on Earth, we use inefficient and costly rocket propulsion technology, which burns fuels to overcome the magnetic gravitational fields of the planet to go to space. We power our rockets, our cars, and our homes by burning matter to release the energy that we convert from one form to another in order to create motion and usable energy. As well, to achieve objectives, rockets, for example, have to carry large and heavy payloads of fuel, which means that they're payload dependent. Matter propulsion technology is very destructive, inefficient, polluting, and wasteful. Now, let's look at the new alternative, plasma technology. Plasma technology uses the properties of the entirety of plasma to create motion, lift, and energy without destroying the characteristics of matter. The system utilizes magnetic and gravitational field interaction to attain positioning and motion. Nothing is burned, there's no waste, and no pollution is created. Plasma technology is efficient and not destructive. Current human scientific achievement is the result of a progressive evolution in science and technology over thousands of years. Plasma technology is the next step in that evolution. It's viable, and it's here today. You could be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology. Apply today to the MOJAN training program. The Universal Council invites you to attend the One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome on the 9th and 10th of September 2016. The Council looks forward to open interaction with the public at the event. Come interact with the Council in your spoken language. The Council encourages you to bring your positive suggestions and solutions to the table on how humanity can move forward as a whole towards everlasting peace. In this way, the work of the members of the Council will become the work of humanity for humanity. The full package price for a single ticket to the event includes 3-night stay in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Accommodations for this package is based on double occupancy. The full package price for 2 tickets to the event includes 3-night stay in a twin bedroom in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Additional night stay are offered at €150 per person per night. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending a single day of the event, the cost will be €200, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending both days of the event, the cost will be €400, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. The One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome. Come share your positive solutions on how we can work together to bring everlasting peace to our world.
Welcome, everyone, to the 117th Knowledge Seekers Workshop of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. It's Thursday, June 9th, 2016, and as for the last 116 Knowledge Seekers Workshops, we are here with Mr. Keshe of the Keshe Foundation, and I believe he's ready to start today's workshop. We'll have a couple of presentations, but I think today Mr. Keshe has indicated we're on a slightly different, or maybe a completely different orientation with the teaching. So, without further ado, let's listen to Mr. Keshe. Are you there, Mr. Keshe?
Yes, good morning. Good day to you, as usual, wherever and whenever you listen to these teachings. Today's teaching, as we said on Tuesday, if you were with us on Tuesday, and we carried on with yesterday's teaching and with the private teachings, we have realized that a number of people have not or could not follow the teaching because it's been so rapid in the past few months, especially in the past 4 or 6 weeks, and for that reason, we are trying to emphasize and bring back that we understand partially the totality of the knowledge of the plasma, and then we go into understanding the usage of it. We have finished with teaching in a way, in a matter state to the plasma state, to other states. So for that reason, we are going through a process that we try more and more to understand how plasma interacts and how plasma comes into operation. The biggest problem for us is we are habitually, for thousands of years, for millions of years, relied on the matter state. And whatever we could not understand in the work of the field of the plasma, we have called it miracles, we have called it different things, but in a way, we never understood the work of the fields, magnetic fields, interaction of the magnetic fields. And even till very recent past, till we have discovered what and how gravity is created, we made gravity the holy grail of science. In so many ways, to accept the change from the mystery of gravity in understanding gravity is the interaction of two magnetic fields we have created and misunderstood and misrepresented the whole science, be it in physics, be it in biology, be it in chemistry, because as I always say, we started with the matter, and we got lost in the use of matter. We become too much attached to matter. Now, we started in the past few decades going further and further into it. We started centuries. We called it the matter state. Then we came to understand a little bit more what we start calling chemistry, where we start seeing interaction of fields or matters with each other. And then with it, we start understanding very much in different ways, different approaches of interaction of the atom. The problem with us as human being has been that we started the wrong way, where we should have started from the point of the creation. We started with the matter state in our hand in different shape or form, and we got and considered everything to be matter and not from fields, because we could not see them, we could not understand them. We could see planets running around, the stars, we could see the sun, we could see ourselves day and night. Gradually we start explaining what was day, what was night. We understood that the earth wasn't a square and the earth wasn't flat, and then we start seeing the sun, then we start understanding more and more about everything else. But the only thing we never considered, the interaction between these entities. What causes them to move and what moves them to interact. So, human race got totally the wrong end of the science. We saw one end which was tangible to us, but we didn't understand where it came from. In a way, now that we understand more and more, we can understand, we can do everything totally different. We started from a state which is totally close together, and we tried to unravel it and try to get into it. Try to understand it more. But in the past, let's say 100 years, that leap in the science due to interactions with scientists around the world has become much more transparent science. But in that process, a lot of people made a lot of assumptions. We made huge amount of assumptions. And whenever a scientist came along and came out with something which was slightly different than the path of the thinking of the past, we went to or we opposed it because we could not understand it. We've seen the amalgamation of the knowledge has brought us here, centuries, thousands of years. Now we call them computers, we call them cars, but go back in the knowledge of the science of the man. We choose fruits, we choose certain foods, because the knowledge of our ancestors passed on to us tells us what fruit kills us, what fruit doesn't, which meat is good, which is bad. These are all the sciences which we gathered. We gathered over thousands of millions of years to choose what fits the balance of the plasma within the body of the man. And then we never understood the totality of it. And this is where the humanity as a whole in the knowledge of the creation got lost. But in pieces have brought the knowledge together. We had, we called, we worked with whatever. We saw the thunder, our ancestors, they thought is the fear of God wanting to punish them. They saw the cover of the moon with the light from the sun, they thought there was another miracle. And we've seen this gradually, now we understand this process, we are unraveling the truth, we are unraveling exactly what everything happens. But one piece of knowledge was missing, and that piece of knowledge was the creation of gravity. Now that we have found how gravity is created, and you lot work with it, you make a coil, gravitational coil and magnetical coil. Now you become familiar with it, now you can feel it, you can understand it, because it interacts with the things you make. Now we can start understanding the depth of the knowledge. So in a way, we started with a matter state, but we came down gradually and we got to plasma. But let's look at it the other way, as I've explained in other teachings. Let's look at the fields. The fields in the universe come together. Some interact, and some do the opposite. This became the gravity, and this became the magnetical or repulsion. Then, when they came together, these fields, in interacting with each other, they created what we call the plasma. Then, when the plasmas got together, we got, let's say, electron and a proton. We saw the atomic structure, what we call physics. In a way, before we see the plasma, the work of the plasma, we came to one step in the knowledge of man, somewhere in the middle here, which we became knowledgeable. We called it nuclear technology, which became understanding this one. Before this level, we just became another scientist. We call them atomic, because our knowledge went further enough that we could understand these two. So we see we went the whole thing the other way around in the world of science. And then when these atomic structures came together, we call them molecules. And this is where our chemistry came from. And then when we got further down, putting more atoms together in a specific combination, mainly in four, we became biology. And this is where our life comes from. And then when we added more to this circle of biology, we came to understand the essence of the creation of the intelligence. And then when we add the six dimensions to it, we came to understand a free plasma condition, interaction of the totality of the two, which gives us what we would like to call the soul of the man. So we went the wrong way in the world of science. We started from here. We saw our physicality. And then we start seeing it, we became physicists, then became chemists, then became atomic physics and nuclear. And then now we understand, if you would have started from this end of the science, you would have had no problem. And this is where we are. This is now why when we speak about plasma and the field is created a mayhem, because it goes against everything we've seen, everything we knew, everything we were thought, and we don't want to accept, or it'll be hard for us to accept. How come we were so ignorant of what we saw every day? Because to go this way needs a lot. You start from the weaker point. You start with very, very weak, and then you get yourself trapped in the whole structure. If the man would have gone from the beginning this way, he didn't have to go all this way, because going this way would have been very easy. But the man, at a point of understanding the matter in a physical state, went the wrong way. He went this way. So now what we show here, we talk about this. And this is what is creating all the mayhem. All the problems that we are wrong, the technology is wrong, because it's the ignorance of the man who has brought this condition on. Because we accepted the matter, and now trying to say for thousands of years has been correct, and we've been wrong, it's against the rule and the grain of the thought of the man. So from now on, we work in one level, on the top. Because now we can manipulate the plasma. We can manipulate the fields of the universe to create any plasma which we like, which with it we can produce any matter we like. And then as we understand more and more, we understand in having this, you go back to the origin of the creation itself. And the fields which have created it. This is why the present plasma technology and what we call the universal knowledge is in such a mayhem with the new world of life and technology and science. Because we have accepted so much that to say we've been bunch of ignorance of the work of the universe is too much. So we create oppositions, we create there is something wrong with it. But now we have seen it's taken hundreds of years for some sciences to be accepted. Now we see universities, scientific organizations are rushing towards accept him because he makes sense and they start working. We are getting now news every week. Different universities have started different collaborations. They are accepting the Keshe Foundation plasma technology as part of now the teachings. We see organizations which are in atomic and nuclear, the highest level in different nations, are supporting because it makes sense, because it answers a lot of unknown. Because a lot of unknown and the systems which are not working, now understanding the work of plasma, we can do it. It can be done. Look at the laws of the thermodynamic. It's through the window, it's finished. But if you can take all the assumptions which was made in thermodynamics, especially the first law, and you can re-explain it, redefine it with the plasma, it'll start making some sense in respect to the interaction of the world of the plasma, field transfer, and matter state. All the assumptions which were made in so many formulas, all the assumptions which was made by scientists to show that they can prove something is working, now those assumptions can be brought into the equation, and some of the mistakes can be corrected, and some of the answers which we could not find in the world of physics, chemistry, or biology, now can be defined, can be explained, can be corrected. It's not that we are changing everything. We are adding to the missing point of assumptions in the physics. You got to understand, a very simple thing. A plasma, electron is a plasma, proton is a plasma. Interaction of electron and proton is two plasmas interacting, creating a field of themselves. We call it atom. This is the base of the present knowledge after 40 years. If you have spoken, or 60 years, if you have said to somebody 200 years ago about atom, they would have said the guy's crazy. When we start talking about chemistry, they became alchemists because they knew, but they couldn't explain. If we would have spoken about proton exactly 100 years ago in 1916, just before the First World War, they would have said the guy is a lunatic. Now you speak about the atomic and molecular and nuclear because we added to the knowledge. But in that process, a lot of assumptions have been made. It's not that the science is wrong. Now we can fill in the assumptions and see if it fits in. Look at all the sciences we've been brought in. Now Einstein brought a subject that the speed of light is the ultimate speed. And we accepted it. But it's wrong. But on the other hand, it's right. The speed of light, which Einstein speaks about, is correct only and only in a matter state of the magnetic field strength according to our point of observation. When you pass that, it doesn't apply. Because now we know, we can explain, we can show, we can create fields which are much stronger, much in strength in gravitational magnetic field above the speed of light, that now we can actually travel with hundreds, thousand times by matter of order of magnitude than the speed of light. So can we blame Einstein or can we support Einstein? Yes, this was the knowledge Einstein had, no more. He worked in the matter state. He could explain in the matter state, but he could see other things, but he could not explain. Now with the plasma technology we can do. Einstein should have stayed a bookkeeper because in that purpose he made a lot of mistakes. He made a lot of assumptions. Look at the structure of the speed of light, the way he calculated it is nothing but assumptions. He wanted to prove M is equal whatever or whatever he came up with, or energy is equal to whatever he wanted to confirm. But Einstein's work as a speed of light is correct in a very small way, but only in a matter state strength. If you go to above matter strength, then you understand that it doesn't work. But if you take the law of Einstein into the matter state of the higher orders, part of it fits. Because the order of plasma technology, the order of field interaction applies across all levels of the universe. This is where we have gone wrong. And this is where we start explaining for the scientists who don't understand what's going on, that all the PhDs they got, all the professorship seats they got, is gone down the tube. Because they worked on those assumptions. And now that we have brought a new knowledge, they have to oppose it because they wasted their life. We've seen people who cannot understand it, they oppose it because their PhD is down the chute. The professorship is down the tube. We've seen the first opposition from the man who supported, and now they find out his work has gone down the chute, is Mr. Winter. We see people from the scientists in the Italian nuclear. They see they're gone. American scientists have the same problem. Because a lot of work they've done has been on assumption. They sit down, they calculate, they see now bringing the speed of the plasma of a different strength of different magnetic fields changes the game. They see the reality, but they can't accept the reality. Because now the degree is worth nothing. They cannot be called doctors or professors. They are a human being. At the end, we can all add to the knowledge. The problem is so immense that we have to change the whole mentality of the understanding of the science of the man up to now by adding to it, but not destroying it. And this adding is creating mayhem for a lot of people. We saw when they added to the knowledge, we became from atomic people to nuclear people. We spoke about atomic bombs, and now we speak about nuclear bomb, and now we talk about plasma bombs and everything which is bombs to kill, where we can use these word of bomb to bomb them and start with a peace, because we can work with the same way. Because what happens is very simple. We started with this part. So the base, if you look at it, is very simple and you understand. We started with physics, which is we could see matter and how matter interacts, and present physics, we work on electron and proton, the basis. Then in the interaction of these, we became to what we called chemistry. Now we have two of them. The more of these interactions, we came in the combinations I explained into biology. When we got this wrong with assumptions, so the whole thing has gone wrong. The physics, the basis of the physics in understanding of matter state by the scientists who brought it up, because of the assumptions they were trying to help to develop the knowledge of the man, in parts has gone wrong, so it goes all the way wrong. In Farsi, we have a say. We say, if you put a brick down wrong at the foundation of the house, the whole wall of the house will be put wrong. It goes in an angle. And this is what has happened. Partially, if you see, I put a straight line, which means part of the knowledge is correct. The other part, which is made assumptions, which is to present knowledge, is not fitting in. But we have to understand, we made huge assumptions, huge scientists, and then to prove it, using the same wrong assumptions, we made more assumptions and more papers to prove each other's wrong. And this is what the peer review has become. The guys who got it wrong, and now they made a club to say they are right, and they call it peer reviewing. So all the wrongs carry on with their own. Anybody comes with anything else, doesn't fit into that wrong, is wrong. This is what we try from now on to bring for you to understand. This is why we see the evolution of the science in a very rapid way. Because now this was in the hand of elite. They called themselves scientists, then they gave themselves titles, professors, doctors, whatever. Where now we become in a very clear division. Here, the scientific world and the degrees and the PhDs. Here, human race, the housewives, the man on the street, plasma technology, making the GANs, making the electronic systems, which are only electronic in the plasma transfer. And that has created and will create a bigger division in the world of the science of the man. Now, the knowledge is so simple that anybody can understand. Where the others who made the assumptions have made themselves so elite that very soon they'll be wasted out. Because a housewife can show, I can make a pen, use the plasma technology, and my child doesn't have a pain. It's finished. We see now, we show later on today, the first Magrav unit in Italy, which is changed from a Magrav to a power supply. Where a man household and the wife takes the pictures. You see the video. The wife takes the pictures because now a housewife, a man on the street, has become plasma physicist. If this lot don't oppose it, they have to pack up and leave. And what we see now, the scientists who have started understanding this, they are supporting slowly without losing any credibility. Because this is the correct way. This is the correct way because they say, we have the knowledge, now we test it, we explain it, we add it. We can tell you in a very short time, universities, teaching organizations, which are started considering to teach the plasma technology as part of the curriculum of the country. Italy is one of them, if I understand correctly. It is possible from next September in Italy, in majority or some of the schools in Italy, the plasma technology of the Keshe Foundation will be taught at primary school level, at teaching of the schools. We see this the same. I received a text from Philippines, from Lennon. We see the same thing in Africa. We see the possibility and now growing of the same thing in a few other countries. It's the nations which accept addition of the knowledge is not a danger to knowledge. The only opposition we see to development of this technology is Jewish lobby. Jewish lobby is financing heavily to suppress the Keshe Foundation work because they worked in a matter state, now they lose all their assets and all the control on humanity. The problem is, we have grown so much on the internet that Jewish lobby, with all their support, bringing people like, financing people like Suzanne heavily to discredit the Keshe Foundation, is not working. We have found the supporters of Suzanne, Jewish lobby. She spent 3 months in Israel to be trained how to oppose, how to make things. And now we understand she's heavily involved in child trafficking. This is not our job. This is for the security services which are working on it, they will release the knowledge and the know-how. Now you understand who is objecting. The reality is, we are all correct. We are all correct. We are all correct in understanding the knowledge. Those who are going to lose have to discredit. You see, from this week, you can go to the banks in Italy and buy a Magrav unit for a few dollars. Very soon we'll supply other technologies. We are on the verge of delivering new technologies which I discussed today, because I give you the basic knowledge and you build on it. Because I have to explain this, because what is going to be discussed from today onwards, it goes even beyond the imagination of a lot of you. Because now you have entered this world. I have to explain to you something before we go any further. Next Thursday morning, we spend half an hour specifically in subject of Alan Sterling, who was now confessed to raping his own children and to be sentenced the following day on the Friday the 17th. We have discovered a full structure with Alan Sterling and his work, and we are paying heavily for the work of people who worked on this section, which is supported heavily by the Jewish lobby. We have found all the contacts, all the hidden houses, all the people who are involved, and how suddenly we found a lot of people, like False Hope, like Red Circle, like the gentleman who turned up here, they're all connected. People like Qumran, on the internet, Keshe Foundation scam, all connected into child trafficking and into selling organs of the children on the health documentation in the West and other part of the world. That's why we received the opposition, because now the wholeness of these people have come out to stop this technology on a path of personality of me and my foundation, where in fact is Jewish lobby heavily financing, because they have no more. The work between the Keshe Foundation and its people is solid. It's 100%. Next week, next Thursday, we spend half an hour, we explain how people like Red Circle and Alan Sterling been working, they are part of the leaders of the child trafficking in the Western Europe and America, and the rest of it. But what we submit is not accusation. We submitted last June, July about Alan Sterling. It took 1 year for him to be arrested. We explained how he was arrested, how we triggered the point. And then you will understand how even to the day we managed to get him to go his confession and hand over himself over. Now, the same process is going on with the Red Circle and the others who are around them. It's 5 or 6 people on the internet covering the whole of internet with all the things to do with me and my foundation. Now we found out they're all paid by one paymaster, and we have found the paymaster, and we can connect to every aspect of it. And we can show the children and the people who they've used or they use for trafficking and the system, then it's for humanity to sort it out. We brought that in the studying out, we've proven to be correct. Now we leave it to you to do the rest. But the problem is the discreditation of the Keshe Foundation came through Red Circle, Alan Sterling, and they've been feeding it everywhere, because now the Jewish lobby, in conjunction with monarchy in Europe, are losing their grip. All the wars have no reason. All the problems, thank you very much, has no reason. So now by explaining the science, you understand, you're all correct. You're all scientists. There is nothing to create psychological doubt in the work of the foundation. We see doctors, we had a teaching with the doctors yesterday, they are testing and they're seeing the changes, because now they can explain what they do scientifically, can be explained in the world of plasma, can be added to help anyone. We see power supplies, we see everything else which is coming in to be delivered, to be correct. The pens you create, we don't sell it to you, it's secret technology. It's the technology of plasma, you're building it yourself. You're taking the CO2, you're taking the GANS. All we are doing, we start teaching the basis of the new addition to the knowledge. And this is important. So from now on, we try to give you not the confidence, but knowing that you were correct, and all these side works has been to distract, to control. For the first time, man is free. For the first time, you understand this knowledge, you are free from everything you want. Energy, shelter, food, medicine, materials, psychological support which you can create for yourself, that with the material which you have, the way it's created in your body, that they cannot abuse you, not on this planet or anywhere in space. We do not need depression in a space by people who take to space, because they can see how they can create, how they can transport, how they can be anywhere at any time. I started these teachings in a very soft way in the past 6-10 weeks. Now we are going to the path of, now that we know matter changes to GANS and the GANS creates fields, now let's play the fields, which is the essence of the creation in the universe. Interaction of the field brings you to be what you want to have. So what we did in a very gentle way, please, there is a possibility we might merge all the workshops Tuesdays and Thursdays together, that we don't call it international workshop and the workshops, because we teach heavily on Tuesdays as much as on Thursdays. So we add the Tuesday teaching into the standard teaching of the Keshe Foundation, because it's not creating. You can follow the teaching in one path. this is important, because I have, then I don't need to repeat to go back what was taught on Tuesday in the international, it all becomes part of one. And as we said, from next Tuesday, we teach at 3 o'clock onwards to the military of the Chinese government and to the space technology of the Chinese government. It will not be open to public unless we come to an agreement with the Chinese organization of the Keshe Foundation. We would like to go public. We run a session with the Chinese in public, but from now on, Tuesdays, if the Chinese allow, we will go into teaching space technology on Tuesday afternoon after 3 o'clock. So one from 2 to 3:30 becomes as part of the standard knowledge seeker teaching, one following another. But from 2 to 3:30, we allocated it for teaching to the military and the space. If you are a man of military and the space, you have to get in touch with Professor Xu in China. He is the head of the Organization for the Space and Military. We chosen a professor with a peaceful nation, and we make China as the head of the space and military for peaceful application of the technology. You can get in touch, we'll make the facilities. The way we have Dr. Klaus for medical, we have the Dr. Gotha for agriculture. We appointed Professor Xu to be the head of the Keshe Foundation in China for peaceful application of the technology for military and space, and he will head the Keshe Foundation military space technology. We allow you, if you're a man of military, being DARPA, being NASA, being Russian Space Agency, being African military organizations, you can all join on the Tuesday closed session teachings, because now we teach all of you. It'll be in Chinese initially, but it'll be in English that you can understand. On the other hand, the Chinese teaching will become part of the teaching, normal teaching of the Keshe Foundation, as we have a huge support in China. Chinese will come back in sharing knowledge and teaching us as much as we teach them. So the way we receive teaching from Ghana, from now on we receive teaching from the university in China for us on regular basis in what they understand, and the Chinese teaching will amalgamate as partially as what they want, and we can satisfy. They are nearly one quarter of this planet population, we cannot ignore, but we can support the knowledge to be spread, because the knowledge of the Keshe Foundation, the plasma in gravitational and magnetical, is very close to ethos of the Keshe Foundation and the Chinese understanding of yin and yang. It makes sense to them, but they need to know how to use it too. But what is the problem? Where do we sit, and where are we going to apply this technology? How we extend this knowledge is very important. It is absolutely crucial for us to understand the whole structure. Now that we understood, you will see what we brought to you. There I explained the work of plasma. Now we start the trip into space and space technology. A lot of you made the nanomaterial. A lot of you made the GANSes. A lot of you, in making the GANSes and coils and the cores, you added to your knowledge and made the pens. In the past few weeks, we encouraged you by teaching you about the coils, how to use the coils in a different formation. If you use it in a flat formation like this, you use it for energy. Fabio, can you bring the lens forward, please? Or is it the maximum? You want me to come close to you, no problem. You see, what we brought to you was this. If you used it in this formation, it allowed you to use for the energy system, magnetic system. You work with it for a few months, you got your confidence, then we allowed and we explained to you to use it in this shape, where now you create a plasma. You see, it's the orientation. Now, in the past few weeks, with the help of those who understood and developed the technology, we brought you to the step of creating systems that when the two cores are at 90 degrees to each other, you create a field. I've been told not to use the pink, you cannot see it. So I go to red. Am I correct? Thank you very much. So we see we created a plasma. For you was too little bit hard to understand. I explained to you very simply. Do you remember when you made, go back on the teaching, when you made the cores, you saw the GANs on the edge, you saw the GANs on the edge, and then you saw the water in the periphery, and then you saw a free space, we could see a gap in the water where the tank was full. That was your system, that was where your energy was. So now with this combination, you can relate to what you have and what you squeeze. Now if you understand, the speed of rotation of this for you will indicate the strength of the gravitational magnetic field, lift or medicine, positioning or creating matter. So what happened? Now we have a rotation this way, we have a rotation this way, and we have a rotation of the GANs. This is one, this is two, this is three. This is one, this is two, and this three. These are the fields of them. And the interaction of these fields now gives you a totally different understanding of freedom. Doesn't matter if you rotate it on its own or carry it as a movement of the plasma. Man has a beautiful tool that not many cultures in the universe have, and that's the matter state. In many cultures in the universe, they don't have this. And it's been a problem to achieve it in so many ways. But man, understanding the knowledge that they have the matter, and with the existence of the matter in making nanomaterial, and with it creating GANs, and with it creating a plasma, and with it creating a field, is a huge knowledge which man adds to the knowledge of the universe. You are not going empty-handed. Man goes into space with the credibility of understanding his own culture and his own texture. So what the problem has been, there's been no problem. You bring a beauty on the table of the universal community, because you can, in the nations, in the cultures of the universe, this makes it easier to teach, because then they can work with. It's not that the man goes into space as subordinate, you go in into space the way we take you, as people who add something extra to the bouquet of the flower of the universal community, with the physicality understanding and the knowledge of the understanding of the totality. Now you have these systems with you. You have the possibility of now controlling, if you increase the speed of one, or you increase the speed of the two, or you make an opposite rotation from one to two, or two to three, you create different conditions. Now you can pressurize with the speed in a way, if you look at it, this now. What you can do with the speed of one or the other, you can dictate now the expansion of this plasma. You can, by compressing it, you go to higher strength, by releasing it, you go to lower strength, you travel with a speed of light by the factor of 20 in the line of the green, you travel by the speed of sublights by number three, or your red one, and then you want to go very slow, that you can penetrate the matter state. We are talking the speed of light. Because now you have in your position the tool of playing with the plasma strength, contracting it or opening it, compressing it to go to the closer spaces, faster fields, stronger fields, be it gravitational or magnetical. Now you see man has in his hand every tool to be in the space within hours. If the man understands the implication and application of the interaction of the plasma. In this process, what I explained in the past few weeks, I brought you to this point. Let's look at something, how you can use this technology, this new understanding, in parts or in the combination of the two in controlling the plasma. We have shown you in the past few weeks, we have Dr. Rodriguez and other doctors around the world start using these on their patients. So we see the results. We see the change in the cancer, we see the change in behavior, we see the change in understanding, and we see how interaction of the fields creates direct interaction with a physical human body. We got doctors at Keshe Foundation, which we run sessions on Wednesdays. We are on the fifth session yesterday, and we start seeing doctors coming in on board, showing how they are using it, what they are doing with it, and how what they see such a rapid changes in their application. Why? Because the plasma they create in the fields, which they are not matured yet, the systems are very preliminary, they are only using this and without rotation. So they have a limited capacity of the field, which because this field is created by lining of different ganses, which is near similar to the body of the man, gives them a field appearance which interacts with the body of a man. What we've done, if I call this A, what we are doing now in the medical section, Dr. Rodriguez and other doctors and the medical people around can tell you, you're putting a bunch of these A's around a person, and as you've seen, this is plasmatic. These plasmas move from one to another, and in that process, body of the man being in the center of it, interacts with the fields, and what it doesn't need or what it needs moves from one to another, cancer reduction. Because you have to understand something important. This is the fear of the man. A man has to understand one thing. Cancer is interaction of the fields which they found the gravitational field strong enough to absorb other energies. And in absorbing, they solidify. Or they make a ball of themselves. But if you look, if you redefine it, then we all have a cancer. Because the body has used this knowledge of solidification to create our bones. So our bones are a cancer part of our body, but the body over billions of years have learned how to use this cancer, solidifying in a correct way. Look at your kidney, it's another way. Your liver is another cancer, your heart is another cancer. If you define a cancer by amalgamation of the points where certain field attraction brings things to it. Kidney creates a field attraction that it brings the liquid of the body to be filtered. Liver does it for other elements. So in a way, when we see a cancer, is the amalgamation of the field which body is trying to adapt itself to it. And if we take the energy from it or allow it with a weaker field by the principle of the plasma where the stronger field reduces its feeds the weaker, as we saw in 129. So as the cancer in the middle of your body is transferring its field to the weaker one and is going, so it has less, depletes itself as energy, and you say it cures cancer. Cancer is not a disease. It's understanding the evolution of the field transfer within the structure of the body of man. So now what we see, we have added, we have to go step by step. We started with the coils, you got your confidence. We started with the coils on two plates that we saw it. Last Tuesday teaching, I brought a new dimension into the teaching of the plasma for health. Now we add a second panel on this side, and a panel underneath, and a panel on the top. Now the fields in the box, if you look from the top, look very much like this. If you look the top view of this, you have a box, a top, and a bottom. This is all but in size equal. Where now you have units here, these are these coils, all the A's as we call them. You have A's here, and you have A's here. Now, when you look at it, go to the patent of the Keshe Foundation we released, you see it's nothing new, it was there. Now you can explain the pattern. You stand the man in a box, which is covered with different strength units. These are facing you, and these are units on the top and the bottom. Now the man stands in a balance boxed. When you stand like this, and when you choose the ganses of these coils of the right order, this section A is interacts with the brain of the man. He has to have the gans of zinc and calcium. This part of the body of the man works with the muscles and tissues, needs to have copper and zinc. This part of the man, it's totally his immune system. The leg of the man is built to create immune system to protect the above. You see the herbs on the ground, the lower the herbs or inside the ground, garlic, mint, any other herbs that are close to the earth. Our bones are connected to the earth to bring the gravitational magnetic field that, like herbs, can disinfect the body of the man. We absorb that kind of energy from our feet, and we convert in conjunction with the energy from the others to protect ourselves. So here you make ganses which strengthen the amino acid immune system of the man. Here you create condition where absorbs fields into the system. So these coils at the bottom have to be majority gravitational. You create coils that allows the surplus, what is not needed, rejected from the coil, from the box. Your coils on the top are mainly magnetical. Now you see the shape of the future space technology and the health of the man. It's very simple now that we understand the secret of the creation. We are here as messengers of God to support man into space the correct way. And we deliver as long as you can understand the process. When you don't, we stop and we let you to mature. Now it's for man to move on. Now you've seen the box of health. You've seen a Magrav health system, which is in totality the total structure of the delivery of the health of the man. As you see, the sides, if you look at it, sideways here, This plate is like this. It has Maglev units on this way. This Maglev system here is a singular magnet gun system because it's the thickness of the mat. There is the flatness of the mat. So you see everything is perfect. But this, if you understand that now you have capability to interact and develop systems which goes with the application and implication of the systems, you can put a man in this box supporting for a few hours and leave him out to adjust his own amino acid and RNA and DNA, and then bring him back out in, and then you confirm the existence. People walk out of the illness within minutes and hours, as we see the doctors are reporting. But now, you understood the box. Now, you understood that this box has a man in it. You understand that this box has a field in it, where now that you have the man is created from his physicality to his emotion, and the interaction of the emotion and physicality creates like electron and proton, what we call the Coulomb barrier of the man, which is within the field of it itself. This is called the soul of the man. If you can control the fields in that green box, then the man can become anything when you carry his soul, when you carry the emotion of totality of the Coulomb's barrier of the man, what we call another word for it, the soul of the man, into anywhere in a space. And when you deliver it, it'll deliver you the man according to the environment which he lands. So now for us, it's important to enter what we call the world of transportation in the universal dimension. This is important because you cannot build a ship and go to another place or send yourself from another position in the universe back to an environment which in a body condition of the man you melt. You want to land on the surface of the sun with your body physical condition, you're burnt out. But if you transfer the plasma of the totality, what we call soul of the man, in understanding the soul will lead to the creation of the emotion and the physicality at the point of delivery according to the strength of the position, then you can land anywhere. On the coolest part of the universe, on the hottest part of the universe, but because you carry the intelligence and the emotion with the full integrity of decision making and survival. Now, you made the box. You made the box, and we see gradually how others are developing it with, as we said, all the A's. Now, you understood this. Now, how do you transfer the soul of the man or the physicality of the man from one point of the space into another, fully intact? If you do it by atomic and the molecular, every single cell, you're in a problem of again going from matter to plasma. But if you do it in the field of the plasma strength, it's a game for children to play. But don't forget, you already have a tool in your hand. You already have seen part of the work of the system. Now, how do we get man in what you like to call teletransportation, or what we call Maglev positioning of the energy of the life in the universe? Let's start. This thing doesn't want to let me to move it. It's okay. if you understood the use of the coils, not in a static condition, but in dynamic condition. If you understood the work of the cores in a dynamic condition, if you understood the interaction of the dynamic core and the dynamic core, and then you can replicate it in a dynamic plasma condition now that you have created it like the medical unit, you will understand something very simple. As the cores rotate, and as you compress the inner plasma, now you can go to create fields which you have seen without rotation of the field strength of the body of the man. We've seen change in the cancer. We've seen the fields have created that interacts with the emotion of the man. So, we see the doctors reporting, using these systems, people change totally. They're happy, they change. They understand their position in their condition they are. So, now we understand, with the scientific backing of the doctors who are in this position with the foundation, we're creating a technology, we're creating plasmatic gravitational magnetic fields, which are both simultaneously in the emotional level, and both in the physical level of the man. Now, what have you missed? My friends, the same reactor, if you can speed it up the right way, will give you the soul of the man the strength too. There is no difference. There is no difference just because you hadn't had the knowledge to understand it, now you understand it. If you make the systems to rotate, to be used, and understand the strength of the magnetic field, gravitational field of the soul of the man, you will create the man. You shape the man. You can construct the man according to environment, because when the soul of the man's strength is transferred, and when it comes to a position, it'll manifest itself in the shape of its physicality. So, now, let's see how and what soul comes to understand. Who will come to show the totality of their existence? Because everything in the universe has a magnetic field, gravitational field strength. Now that you understood this, now that you understand the simplicity of it, let us open the door of the universe to man. It takes you time to develop this, but by the time you develop it, you will understand how you can transport yourself across the universes if you know the destination strength. You saw the walls, and you put the man inside the walls. You created in your system a small anomaly. The anomaly comes in the gap in the system. Now, create a system where the man is encircled in totality by the field. With one difference. I have to choose a color which they're happy with. Now you created rotation of the plasma in one direction. Create a rotation of the plasma in the same strength, in different direction. If you look at it from the top, the man is in the center with his hands and legs. The system is like this. But these are equal circle going down. And it's this way. In equal circles going around. Now, you have a problem. In the structure of this system, you have to bear in mind one thing. You have a man which has a given a specific gravitational magnetic field, which its body absorbs fields from its environment at a given strength, and it gives the same energy as a given strength to confirm its existence. If the energy is too much in receiving or giving, we call it the burnt, the guy exploded or whatever. If you take it away, we got the guy frozen and is dead. Now, you have to understand this process because it's important for you. Now, go back into the teaching where we came this way. Now, you understand this very easily. When you make your coils to go like this, you have to make a specific system. Then you can dictate. I call the pink, let's call it one. You put the man in the center with his legs and his arms. You create one. Oops, he doesn't like it. Our camera people don't like this. They say they can't see it. You can see it, I can use it. So, doesn't matter, let's do it differently. So, now this becomes your one. This is your first part. Now, you're containing the body and all the fields of the body. This is the strength of the gravitational magnetic field of a human being on its point of creation, which is Earth. You want to go to planet Zeus, you want to join us there. We call it this way. I think it'll be better this way. Now, how do you create this? You need to have a second coil, which is now your magnetical coil, or we call it two, the strength of destination. In time you understand. As you change the fields, and you pass it the way you've done, you already pre-done this, you have to educate yourself. You move in these coils from gravitational to magnetical, you dictate now the magnetical with the way you do it to be the strength of the destination. You transport the man in the essence of his soul from one point to another, and it manifests itself at the point of arrival exactly with the same intelligence, same emotion, physicality acceptable to the point of presentation. And this is why you see so many creatures, they suddenly disappear on this planet, now that you have cameras and you can record it. Because they decide the point of presentation, the point of appearance. So, the coils you make in reality is the stacking of these units in a correct way, magnetical, and what you literally do, what I taught you, and what you see very much in this stacking unit from our people. Fabio, can you show this, please? It's okay, I've got it. Now you have a stacker unit in the center. You have double coil. The center coil becomes your gravitational. The outer core becomes your magnetical. And in fact, what you see here as the crystal is the man itself. Now you understand why we start teaching the Maghreb unit. In a larger scale, in condensing and adding numbers, but with a singular gravity magnetical field, singular gravity magnetical field, done correctly, the structure of the Maghreb units and done in appropriate way is your machine into space. To be manifested at anywhere in the space according to your strength. Now you understand. You have to create both gravitational and magnetical field in both layers, because otherwise you lose the identity of the passenger. This is how transportation, in the essence that you can manifest yourself anywhere in the universe, has been done. This is a gift from us to man, to allow man to join the universal community. We have opened the door, and it's for man to respond correctly, that we can teach more. Make the coils the way you've done. Governments have these finances to do, and stand in between. If you get it correct, you choose the destination of your soul. You will see the strength of your soul, and this is how we choose the council members of one planet, one nation, one race. Because we see the light they emit, and the brightness and unity of uniformity of the light within the structure of the creation. Blessed those who understand. Now you understand how we are on the process of developing a full system for man to survive in the worst conditions in the universe, and the best condition in the universe according to his emotion and his physicality. It is important that you understand the totality, not part of it. All we've done in this process, if you look in the Maghreb system, we put a little ball in the middle. Now the ball in the totality of verticality is the man itself. It carries his emotion, it carries his physicality, and because it's made of it, the man becomes the light of the creator in the essence of the creation. Christ, blessed his name, has done it, but man has been blind to it because they looked at the physicality of it. Buddha touched it, but never understood it. Because Buddha, blessed his name, detached himself from physical matter. He could work on the level of the soul, but he could not see the transportation of the soul from the man, from the village of the earth, into universal condition. Now we teach all. You got to understand the totality of the structure of the work of the plasma and the fields of the universe. If you look at it, you write the letter. You fold the letter and you put it in an envelope. And whatever is written in that letter, because it's in that envelope, will be delivered at the point of delivery to whoever is the recipient. Now, the number one in the center is the letter. And the green number two is the envelope. And according to the law of the transportation of magnetic field, you do not need to take long to get to your point. Instant transportation to the point at the speed of the choice. Now, let's say if you have a criminal hiding somewhere, you have his clothes, you have essence of scent like the dog can trace, you can replicate it, he can hide within the deepest holes on this planet. We can find him instantaneously where it is. You lose a child, instantaneously we can find out where the child is. Because now we can create with the same system the magnetic gravitational field of the scent, which is again part of the structure of the emotion, to the destination. Now those rulers who have killed, raped and pillaged, when they raped the child, the essence of the child is still on their body. All we need to do, we don't need a blood test anymore. We can find, if finds a match, the criminal stands in front of you. There shall be no place where the rulers of the world, for their misconduct, abusing their power, can hide anymore. This technology and this knowledge will be so rapidly developed around the world by scientific and governmental organizations, and by the women in the kitchen and the men in the garages. This is the problem. Women are doing the whole technology in the kitchen and men in the garage. When we bring the men in the kitchen and put the women in the garage and they work together, they'll make everything together perfectly. And we see, you have the clothes of your child has gone missing in Africa, and you put it in the system, you create the sense of its field, and it dictates itself, is in a palace somewhere in Belgium, the king is fried. And it'll be done in the coming days and months. We ask the world leaders to stand up themselves, to bring out their own misconducts, that man does not need to judge them, because the judgment of the man has been very harsh in hanging and destroying. The palaces of the kings will have no room, as they've been suffering in them too much. Now you understand. The problem is how you can develop this technology in its essence. The problem is how you can control it, that you don't end up in the ocean instead of Bahamas. You have to create the right condition of the environment you want to land in. Transportation will be the backbone of the space technology of the Keshe Foundation, because now you understand the totality. Even though this is what I've taught you up to now, is a scratch on the surface of the knowledge of the universe. Even with this scratch, some have problem to understand. Make the coils the inner of the copper. What are you going to do with the coil outside for your magnetical? Do you use the mixture of the GANS liquid to create the plasma. Now you're not conditioned to anywhere because you create the mixture, you create the strength between the gravitational and magnetical of the two. You decide the point exact, precise, even somewhere in the middle of the universe where you want to meet your mother. Mom, I see you at the petrol station and the fuel station and the motorway. Well, you specify the point in the space because you can give the strength, direction and the position at that instance. And as it changes, so your field changes, you can never make a mistake. You both meet at the same spot in the universe. Because now you have tuned to be of the same strength change and the same position change. Travel in space is so beautiful. Universe has more to offer for man to be busy, to travel, to enjoy, than ever making things to tie himself to a house, to a room, to a car and to palaces. I own none because I know the value of the work of the universe. That's why I give all my work to humanity and the foundation, as I have my own home and palace of the universe to live in. I wonder how many men will change. The totality of the strength of the fields you create will show your emotion. The totality of the fields you create shows the truth about your direction. The totality of the fields you create shows the state of your emotion and condition of your soul. And don't forget, go back to the beginning of the teachings. I said, when you build these spaceships, people will not walk into it because they judge themselves, they know what they've done, and the universe will not take criminals. Because the criminals will not dare to enter, because their composition will land up in a place we'd like to call hell, when the physicality does not appear at the strength of the physicality, when the two tear apart. So, how do we create these systems? Now, you are more or less halfway at this stage. How do we get you to this stage? Chinese are ahead. They start producing mass production of GANSes. All of you are creating few grams here and there to produce the plasmatic condition of composition of the elements of the universe. You need mass production of GANSes that with it you can dictate the physicality of the man to the liquid water of his existence. As I said, by my arrival to China, within short time, we put China into a space beyond the imagination of the man. Mars is a gameplay. Would you like to see any of the galaxies? Join China in peace process of the demilitarization and the unity we teach you. Stay out to criminalize, you stay out and you have nowhere to exist. The process is very simple. Go to your understanding. Creating these magnetical and gravitational, you need to understand the interaction of the fields of the plasma. And then there is one little problem which I haven't told you. Maybe I tell you because a lot of you will face it. This is what you like to call the Coulomb barrier of the man or the soul of the man. This soul of the man has his own strength. And to be accepted, to be correct by universal community, has to be the strength of the universal community, strength too. To be next and part of you have to have the same strength. There is no place for lying and cheating on the surface, yes, underneath, no. As we say, the game of play by the Iranian girls. In the front on the table says, I don't love you. And underneath of the table, they pull you to themselves with a leg. That cannot happen in the universe. It has to be all plain, correct, you join. You're part of. It's no use trying to join bunch of men of space who reach this level and you are there. There is no, what do you call them on the ship? When they join you on the board without being knowing, we don't have none because we cannot gain it. We cannot jump in and think because the others have got, I get too. This is why we push and we encourage for unity of mankind that they all think the same way. But you have to change the whole structure of the physicality of this planet. And that takes time if man decides. As I said before, we've seen it many times. When we announced the World Peace Program, the first ambassadorial meeting, Europeans didn't come. Then the Italians broke rank and they came to the second one. And then we came to Italy. And now, today we see Giovanni's got a smile on his face. The Italian press start releasing about the Keshe Foundation. Italy will break rank very heavily because now they have everything. Giovanni walks in today with the Italian newspaper with him. Show it. Because now the process has started, governments and scientists and journalists understand there is no shackles on Jewish lobby. Because it's for the humanity, it's for the nation to save energy, for nation to get better. We are getting involved in every aspect of the culture and living in this country. Decontamination. Trying to sort out something with the sea, something with the earth contamination, the energy. In a coming time, we announced the opening of the Keshe Foundation banking system in Italy. Because this way we can give and encourage the rest of you to do. The way to approach, go and learn from the Africans. Come in contact and work, not so much as you do with public, put part of your effort to go into the scientific organizations, universities, governmental ministries and education and show the benefit of the technology. And tell them, yes, there is a lot of things against Keshe Foundation, we are fraud and everything, because it was paid by Jewish lobby. And it was put in there by conjunction of the Illuminatis and monarchies, as we've seen with the Belgium, with the Jewish lobby to create as much mayhem that in discussion, everything gets lost and they win. But this time they lost. Because too many people are creating. Tell them, we're wrong, no problem. But I'll give you a pen. You have a pen, put it on the pen. If it works, we come back to the next one. Start showing the working and the beauty of the technology. We give an advice to those who made so much mayhem. Shut your websites. Shut all the rubbish you put on the internet about Keshe Foundation and write about its correctness and what it is. Or when we put you in next to Mr. Alan Sterling, there is no peace wiki. It's become a peace wiki. Very soon it'll be taken off the internet and all the people who trafficked on it will stand their own sentence. So, our advice is very simple. Bring it together and show the application and the implication of it. As I said on Tuesday afternoons, we started teaching for military in Chinese language, because Chinese army and the space are part of the Keshe Foundation work to understand that we can bring the change as a peaceful nation. If you are of American, we know you're sitting on the communication line of our teaching, but come officially online. We invite NASA, Mr. Nelson, as the head of NASA propulsion. We are prepared to start a negotiation with NASA. You being the flag bearer between the Keshe Foundation and getting NASA in working with us with the blocking of the Jewish lobby in Washington. Now the Jewish lobby is exposed. We are prepared to negotiate with NASA directly at the highest level as we've done before. The same goes with the Russian Space Agency, because the present space technology is useless. It's finished. It is a matter of months that the Chinese will go beyond this solar system and above, and the Americans are still busy if they can feed a few man on the space of this planet. I'll take the Chinese space technology and their military to a level that they don't spend a single cent on army, but on the development of comfort of the nation and the man into space. The team of the Chinese doctors who are working in the background with our technology, we support you to develop the latest health systems for the Chinese population. The other nations can join in. Tuesday afternoons, we teach hardware of military according to the space and not for killing and defense. The military means being able to survive any condition in a space. A space means becoming the military to space, that it becomes one. We don't have any military. We will have the space technology that heads by the Chinese government and by Chinese scientists, because they understood and they took the ethos the correct way. It's important to understand how we interact the fields, and in interacting the fields gives the result. The field we create with Chinese is a field of peace, brotherhood, equality, and we get the reciprocal answer. And that's how we work. And this has to be with the man and the universe too. You have to learn to work that to be transparent. We start teaching heavily. Now, I said to Rick this morning, before I come, our usual talk before we start these sessions, I said I start teaching something today you never seen. Now you've seen. The transportation of the man through the soul of the man, not the physicality of the man. But some of you who don't understand, you laugh. So it means you have not matured enough. It means you lack the knowledge of humanity that has not matured to understand the detachment from his physicality. And what happened? The last minute, the last breath, you say, oh my God, means where is my soul? How can you have a soul serving you when you haven't served the soul? Understand to make systems which are homogeneous. Understand to make systems which are correct according to their application. Understand to make systems which can work in any dimensions, anywhere in the universe. But understand that you need to keep the collective structure of the plasma of the soul of the man intact at any point in the envelope of the transportation of the universe. The postman is you, the envelope is you, and the letter is you. If you understand what I've just said. I wish I was in New York. I wish I was in London. I wish I was in China. I wish I was with my son. I wish I was with my daughter. I wish I was with my loved one. That wish becomes your reality. go back on the teaching of Tuesday. We saw with the purity of African nations, with the purity of the true blood of the man, how Paul showed us the same water, the same metals, the wish of the man created the CO2 or CH3 or copper oxide. As I said, the African nations will bring the beauty of the creation on the table of humanity, and we see the step by step. Now you understand what I said 2 minutes ago. You are the letter, you are the envelope, and you are the postman. Go back on the teaching of the Tuesday, where Paul from Togo showed you how that bottle of water is the water of creation of the man, and within it, man wishes where and how to appear what he likes. Now you understand. The water, 95% the body of the man. Time to create the GANS. But the GANS appears according to the wish of the man, to the place of the man, to the delivery of the man. Wish peaceful, you will achieve. It'll be very interesting. In the coming time, when it's the first time man will see, and this is the pleasure of the creation. You know, I call them beautiful people, you call them schizophrenic. When you build these systems as they are on the screen, you will see not the physicality of two or three, you will see the soul of two or three. And then you understand how misguided man has been in understanding the reality of the creation, even of itself. Because within the environment of the system you make, you will see three souls. Each one individual with his own strength, or two souls. Or as we have the advisors to the American government, with 11 souls. Maybe that's why the Americans are so clever, because they have somebody with 11 souls in every dimension. And he's been advising 6 past presidents. Now, this is what I explain. In the coming time, you will see the strength of the soul. And if you have three, you shall see. If you have two, you shall see two. Then man respects, not as an illness, but as a beauty of the creation, to respect the three and enjoy the three. Then those of you who claim to be pure, your soul, the condition of the interaction of physicality, of totality of your body, will show the reality of the intention. Horrible time. What do you call this? The truth injection. You know, they give you an injection and you tell the truth. Now you have the plasma truth injection. Let's see, I tell you I love you, and you say, I love you too, darling. It should be clear, now goes black. Uh-oh. Was I the liar or you? I am going to be the American president and I bring peace, but already been paid by the Jewish lobby to create as much war as I can. Black. Black shall not be the skin of the man, the black shall be the soul of the man. This is the beauty of the new technology. This is the beauty of the extension of the knowledge in the world of the creation. Now, because you have started creating the plasma of the structure as one plasma, as a liquid plasma, and the fields created it, it has one dimension, not a mixture. It's not an alloy. Is the Maghreb strength combination. That's why when you look at the water, you see nothing in it, but it's all the same. But in time, when you understand to measure the real, you measure the color of the plasma before you added the GANS to it, and you measure the color of the plasma after you add GANS to it. And then you see it's not the same color. It's not the same transparency. But because in totality, every cell has increased the way of the way it works in plasma technology, you see the same. Start understanding the strength of the plasma, how it is. If you have doubt in it, I see people are coming up with new ways of confirming the existence of the plasma. This morning on the way, I saw something on the spaceship group of the Keshe Foundation. It was beautiful what I saw, but I thought, I wrote him text. Can you send this to Rick? Now, we show the reality with a pen. We show the reality with the others. We see how others are trying to confirm in their own way the existence of the plasma in the totality. Jackie, are you on the line?
Yes, I know.
Have you sent the pictures to Rick? Can you display them and let Jackie explain what he's seen and what he's done, please?
Yeah, sure. Just get this lined up here.
I'm getting good. Learning how to use this thing. Fabio, you'll have no job here very soon. I just learned a few tickets. I become the creator now. It's very narrow. Okay, can you explain for us, Jackie, please?
Yes, sure. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Mm-hmm.
Okay, because I'm on mobile. So this is an egg.
Can you speak a bit louder? And there is a. Okay, can you explain to us what you've done?
Yeah, so I see the kids workshop, the first kids workshop where you explain how you can play with an egg. So this is the egg, and then I put into vinegar.
Yeah.
And after a few days, you will see the next pictures.
Yes.
It was like a bouncing ball, but the egg falls into the floor, so I have the separation, and it become like the yolk becomes more solid like this. It's like a small ball, and this total separation with the yolk and the white. And so I decide to play with that this substance. So I put. Next picture. I put into the liquid plasma, the CO2, and I put a little bit of CH3 to give some energy to this. And I put, this is the first, yeah. And then I put some caustic soda, and normally it need to become like a GANS. But it don't become like a GANS. It becomes like a new shape, a new form of plasma. It's become totally like this ball, but in a new kind of matter, you know?
Why did you put the caustic soda in it? What happened when it was just a GANS?
Is not becoming like a GANS. When I put and I want to make the GANS, it become like that.
So what happened if you put just a yolk in a GANS? What happens?
It's become the caustic soda and the other element doesn't change anything. It so is,
if you haven't put up, if you have not put the caustic soda in it, you still get the same shape.
Absolutely. The caustic soda, the hydrochloric acid, all the kind of things doesn't change anything.
So this is what you got when you put it in the CO2 GANS and the CH3 GANS.
Yeah, absolutely.
So everybody can test this and let us see. And then this explains to you the energy of the GANS. Because if you put GANS water in the water and put the yolk and you get the change, then it confirms to you more about the existence of the energy of the GANS. We've seen how we choose the GANS in different ways. This is beautiful. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. And you can see the white, the next picture.
Yes, we see the white, the next picture. We see the fourth picture. Or do you have more pictures you can share with us?
Yeah, I don't have it right because I'm in my phone. But the white is totally different. The whites become like the other GANS. But the yolk doesn't react the same. It's totally different.
If you're online, please try. If you have the GANSes, mix the GANSes and put different yolks in it, different eggs in it. Let's extend the knowledge. Let's see if the transfer of the energy in a plasma condition will give you what you're looking at.
Yeah, I understand.
And this show, because all of us for centuries have put egg in the water and nothing happens, it stays egg. They make a scrambled egg in the hotels with it because it's cheaper. It gives it the more volume when you put water in it. If you can put the yolk of an egg or the white of an egg or any other thing, these are little confirmation of you're dealing with energy, you're dealing with the plasma energy. If it is correct, and how much correct, and what is the correctness, what strength you reach, maybe you have to increase the amount of the CO2. Water. Maybe you have to deal directly with CO2. Maybe if you use different GANSes of different strength, you can float the egg in between cooked or looking like this. So this is to give you confidence that you're dealing with the energy system of a plasmatic condition.
Yeah. It's absolutely that.
So thank you very much. Thank you very much. As usual, you bring us gorgeous gifts.
And you know, the beauty is just why I am on the phone, because I'm catching the friend of Paul who is doing the Togo Foundation. And I just catch him in the station. So it's the beauty of the plasma world.
The plasma people meet in the train stations and underground.
Yeah, you want to say hello to the friend of Paul, Togo Foundation? I just give him 1 second.
Thank you very much. Let him introduce himself. Hello, good morning.
Hello, Mr. Keshe.
How are you?
Just arrived. Fine.
Can you explain to us who you are and what's your connection with Togo Keshe Foundation, please?
Yes, I'm the president of Keshe Foundation Togo. And I arrived in France, and I ask to Paul, my friend, we are working together.
Your name?
My name is Paka Agew.
Welcome, Paka.
Paka Agew. Thank you, sir.
Explain to us what you're doing. We saw beautiful work with you in Togo. You brought a new horizon in the understanding of the cancer with us on Tuesday, and it'll be nice to can you explain more to us what's happening in Togo with the Keshe Foundation and what you're developing?
Please, can you come again, please?
Yes. Can you explain to us if you have time, or we give you another time on Tuesday if you are there to introduce more about Togo. Togo is a new, organization into the Keshe Foundation.
Yes, so we are okay. We just begin, and we are trying to have our with authorities to be in how I can tell it. I'm not very strong in English speaking.
Speak in French. Francois can explain, or Caroline is downstairs, she can translate.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. It's really better.
Thank you.
I can translate if you want.
Francois, sorry.
Yes, I'm here.
Yes. If you can make a presentation the way you did last Tuesday, mm-hmm. and explain to us what you are doing with your government and what is happening in Togo. By the way, I have to explain to you something while you're online. Please tell Paul to get in touch with Benjamin and Dr. Gota and Alex that you join us in the African Summit in Ghana in October, please. You are invited. Please join us.
He said, okay, no problem.
Thank you very much indeed. Let me translate.
I will translate to him all.
Okay, thank you very much indeed. Make a small video of the explanation how they do in Togo, and we will understand more and more.
Yeah, thank you so much, Mr. Keshe.
Thank you very much for your beautiful work, Jackie.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you indeed. We see the work people like Jackie, we see the work of people in Germany and the other places which are pushing the introduction of the knowledge and technology. We see a hidden man behind a lot of work in Italy, Giovanni. He works heavily in all directions, with governments, with universities, with institutes, with privates, anybody, anywhere. That is one of the reasons for the success of the Keshe Foundation in the structure of the Italian organization. People who are devoted, the same with our partners in the Keshe Foundation factory. They have brought the Keshe Foundation and the work of it to the level of understanding of governments and what they call the financial world. They see us now as a new generation of money making. And that's why they like us to work with us. But they don't understand soon the money will have no value. We need people. We hear an Iranian working very hard in Germany, teaching anyone and anywhere. Soon we'll bring him on the table. You will know him. He is on all sorts of Keshe Foundation teachings in Germany. We see people working like Renan and the Keshe Foundation Innovation Team in Philippines in bringing the technology at the level of the governments. Governments and scientists are responding to this technology because they can see it. It's very simple. We saw a pen taking the pen away. You see the water contaminated, you can drink it. There is no ambiguity. There is no discreditation and there is no scam. The scam at the moment sits with the Jewish lobby. The hand has been opened, the same with those who sit with the Organization of Financing World and Communication. We don't have a problem. Our problem is it looks too good and it works too good. That's the only problem. The only problem is you have to start having the confidence that when you show it, you know it. We saw it. If that egg condition which is there, you've seen it, you walk into the office of a president, you walk into a health authority, you say, I have a new cooking machine. This is your water, this is my water. I drink it and I put my egg in it and it boils and it's there, it's cooked. Then there is no ambiguity. You don't need to wait for test results. As the doctor yesterday said, the result is so immediate. We can measure it in the blood test within 24 hours, 48 hours. The purpose of the work of the foundation from now on is to solidify and give you confidence that what it is correct. Because now, as I said, we know where the scam came from. All the scams on the Keshe Foundation centered at Alan Sterling, Now we have opened his Facebook, we see all the collaborators and all the false charities and child trafficking and everything else which has come up. Very amazing. Six people took the whole world into what they call hijacking, because they've done it for so long. Red Circle has abused his own children so long that to him is habitual. Now we have name of five victims, two murdered by the hand of Red Circle. We will publish their names. So the conviction is on the table. Confirmation by their own writing, not by us. Now, we have two of his daughters raped by him. We have two murdered children linked to him. And he has his own writing, exposure, pissing in the garden in front of the child. Criminal offense by any standard, even by the standard of Belgium government. Now you see five people who went out to discredit, now they found out they're captured. We'll give, and one of the world medias soon will release all the details. That then you read it in a newspaper, you believe it, because this is the short sightedness of you, how these four or five people, through the support of the king or ex-king, have managed to kidnap the whole humanity from being free from such a new, beautiful technology that all of you can benefit by it. It took training of a what I call twisted eye woman to go to Israel, get financed, trained, to create interviews and everything else, to become one the Iranian, one the Jewish, one the any other color, as long as they can import children from Asia into Europe. We have opened all the tracks. But now, Red Circle, we have message for you. We got your two daughters you raped. Same as Alan Sterling, that's why you supported him. Now we got two murders attached to you, you've been cause of, you've been part of. You confessed to the fifth one yourself. So by any standard, we'll take you to European Court of Justice and we'll pass your sentence by the law. Right, the more you write, the more you have exposed all of it. And now the security services are coming in. 11th floor is the right place to be. Nowhere to escape. Carry the technology by its strength. Carry the technology by its beauty. And then we forget about this bunch of hooligans who have kidnapped the world from a new technology and science. We got to understand. We got to understand the reality and the totality. Try to play. You've seen how simply Jackie with an egg gives the confirmation of the plasma. Change your plasmas. This way, maybe the position of the egg in respect to will give you new measurement for the strength of your system. If the egg floats, what's the measurement for it? Do we make another egg time machine as an egg strength machine? To understand the strength of the plasma. These are how we are back to the beginning of a new science, and all of us, every single one of us is a plasma scientist. Be it a woman in a kitchen, a man in a garage, a professor in a university, a doctor in a surgery, if we can use this technology to bring comfort to another man, we have served our purpose. This is how we increase the soul of the man's strength by receiving. The soul of the man is very much like a huge gravity machine, waiting for anything to be given to it to be able to give more, to shine more. When you help a man with the pain, that he has no pain and says, God bless you, It means I give you part of my soul, and your magnetic gravitational system goes into operation to catch every piece that is given you. Is in the writing of Baha'u'llah, blessed is his name. I made man to create children that they may love me, which means they give from their soul that elevates my beauty. This is the job of us, all of us. We know we give, but sometimes we can't give all in one go because it's not people. The knowledge is not ready to receive, because with it they can damage themselves. I've given the example of the old woman with a house in a desert, on the edge of desert, with a king, which knocks on his door and he says, "Woman, I'm thirsty." She opens the door, she says, "Wait, I'll give you some water. You have to wait a few minutes till I get the water." The king waits. The woman opens the door and hands over a bowl of water, cool and sweet, with the sugar cane. But she leaves the pieces of the cane on the top of the water. The king, being thirsty, wants to drink in one go, but he can't, because the pieces of the wood of the cane keeps on interrupting his drinking. When he drinks enough, he says, "Woman, what have you done this? Why didn't you give him? Why did you put the wood in?" She said, "My friend, my king, if I would have given you the whole water and you drank it in one go, because of your thirst, you expanded your stomach and you would have died. This way, you took it slowly, the body absorbed, it overcame your thirst, and you're here." And this is the same, and this is the story of a king of Iran. It's not something made up. And this is the same with a man. If we give you the chalice of knowledge in one go, you'll be drowned. So, in bit by bit, we take the pieces of the straw out of the water, that you can drink more, because now you are satisfying the thirst of the man for the new knowledge. It is our job and your job as the people who are familiar and close, and you understand more because you've been here longer, to teach correctly, to teach in accordance to what your people understand. Don't try to show to be very clever, to put everything on, because they don't understand, that they can't admit to their own lack of knowledge and strength of understanding, then they oppose you. Show an egg, show water which can kill an animal, and you put a drop of water, you drink it and nothing happens. This is how we have to behave. This is how we show the understanding in a small measure. I was on the table with one of the richest men in the world past few weeks, and I put a drop of the gans of the water in a cup of water in front of him. He was very apprehensive. I drank it. He said, "Do you know something? We go to India a lot. This can help me. I can take it with me. If any infection or any water I take, I'll put a drop of this in it. I don't have to have diarrhea every time I'm in India." Immediately understood. Keshe Foundation financed by $1 billion by one of the richest men in the world. You will see the investment which comes into Keshe Foundation by world leaders, by world scientists, by wealth of the rich to support the poor. Not asking for any return. This is how we have to reach the people. They can see it because they know it, how it affects their life. You will meet this man very soon. He's proud to be able to use the technology. He's proud to take the technology in his country and other places and be part of it, because his motion is to serve humanity. Wealth has come as part of the natural process of commercialization of the country. We are breaking through by example. We are breaking through by positive delivery of the technology, and my job from now on is to show more and more, more application by the knowledge seekers of the Keshe Foundation around the world. Go back to the Tuesday teaching of Togo. Go back to last Thursday teaching by Ghana. Today, 5 minutes, 2 minute presentation of the egg from Switzerland. Everything, everything. You should have joined us yesterday with the doctors, how they're applying the technology to their patients and the results they're reporting. Join the people who are delivering systems, which is now for the first time, Maghreb units have become free power energy supply here in Italy. Rick, can you, have you received a video from Fabio?
Yeah,
would you like
to put that on?
This is the first time we show this in public. He is one of the teachers of the Keshe Foundation. He has used the technology. This is a Maghreb system which is built by Giovanni for this gentleman in November. He helped him to make it. And now you can see this is a man-made simple system in Rome. And what you see is happened on Tuesday. It's videoed by husband and wife. And please play it, then you understand what to expect from your Maghreb system. It's the second, third time we see this one. We've seen this already in London. Now people who've been on the system for 5 or 6 months or a year are reporting this. So please play the video. Wait 1 second. I give the microphone to Giovanni to translate because it's a lot of Italian.
It's in Italian, I was going to say.
Yeah, just 1 second, please. Fabio, can we have the microphone? The hand phone, the hand microphone, is it working? Yeah, because Giovanni has to translate. Or, Giovanni, use my microphone in my pocket.
Carry on, please. Buongiorno a tutti.
What? Are we connected? Mario? You should be. Carry on. You can play the video.
Okay.
Carry on. You translate.
Yes.
Qua non c'è luce.
There is no light here.
Andiamo immediatamente in cucina. E
now we go in the kitchen.
Non c'è luce.
There is no light.
Niente. Qua?
Nothing.
Sulla cappa?
On the upper part of
niente
the kitchen.
Funzionante.
Scusa,
nothing work.
Che la lampada è
quella. Benissimo,
là.
Niente.
Allora, there is no light.
Qua c'è il frigo che è attaccato al Maghreb. Ecco, vedete.
This is the fridge that was connected to the exit of Maghreb. This
dentro,
is the wire.
Qua c'è poca luce.
Inside, there is no light here.
In questa presa di corrente qua.
There is
allora,
no light.
Vedete, ha pulsato il frigo. Ed è funzionante,
fridge,
signori miei.
There is the light. There
eccolo
is
qua.
Lord.
La prova. Che il Maghreb
this is the proof that the Maghreb is working and give the energy
ecco
to the fridge.
Alcune cose, non tutte quante.
E no, sta alimentando appunto.
In questo momento.
Ah, ecco, possiamo accendere questa lampada.
The Maghreb give the energy.
Eccola anche la lampada, signori miei. In questo momento il Maghreb sta alimentando una lampada
the
e il frigorifero.
The Maghreb is working and give the energy to the fridge
questo
and the lamp.
La prova. Grazie,
and the light.
Thank you very much
to all. I'm
molto lieto di aver costruito questo Maghreb.
Really happy that I built this Maghreb.
Siccome prima non c'era la luce, vi faccio vedere.
Before there is no light,
non essendoci elettricità,
I show to you there is no
electricity.
We have the capacitor in
action. Qua c'è il filo.
There is the wire
del Maghreb.
Of Maghreb. That
la
go
cialata,
that give energy to the multiple socket that
sia
is
il frigorifero
that I show to you now.
Che la lampada.
And this multiple
in
socket.
In questo momento la luce non c'è in casa. Oggi
and
è il 7
the lights,
di giugno del 2016 e l'Enel ha detto che tagliava la luce fino alle 14. Perciò stiamo alimentando le nostre cose
and
col
the energy. Company give a letter to us that there is no electricity today. Thank you for all.
Thank you very much. Now you see the first delivery of the power energy by Magrav system independent of the main, because the plasma is charged enough to be able to run the fridge and the light. We have received a number of these reports, but the gentleman is a teacher in Italian section of the Keshe Foundation teaching and is made by himself. You can test your Magrav system every now and then to see when it's becoming gradually a power supply. The technology is perfect in essence. The technology is essence in its knowledge. And now, as I said on Tuesday, we start strengthening to give you the confidence that the mayhem created by Red Circle, because he was discovered to be a head of a child trafficking organization in Europe, did not want it to be exposed. Now he's exposed. And his collaborator, the man who he trusted as his right-hand man, brought into Keshe Foundation, is spending minimum 25 years in prison for raping two girls, age of 3 and 4, his own daughters. The same, they say a very simple thing. Birds with birds, wolves with wolves. And we've seen the wolves. Try to explore the knowledge. Try to explore the expansion of the knowledge, and don't wait for patents. There is no patent in the universe. We don't have a European patent office, we don't have a world patent office, and we don't have a universal patent office. So try, play, and bring the knowledge. A lot of you know we are running. Next week, you start receiving the emails regarding the GANS trials for the skin, for the eye, and for the lotion. We've been told by next week we'll receive the certification that we can release the materials. We are waiting for certification. This is why you have not received your materials, because once we certification, we transport, we are covered. And we've been told it'll be done, tests have been done, confirmation have been received, that you will receive your emails. On a confirmation of the emails, application form submitted back to the Keshe Foundation Health, then you start receiving. If the countries are of those which don't allow receipt of the material, we send you the instruction what to do. You can build it yourself. Don't forget, you paid to become part of a survey worldwide. We don't go to pharmaceuticals like them to go and borrow billions. We participate ourselves to pay for the people who sit to organize and give their time to bring the data and everything else together. €120 for research, development, volunteers is nothing compared to what is delivering. As part of this, as I explained on last week or last Tuesday, I started using the CO2 GANS for myself because I suffer from a very bad eye degeneration. Now we see the process. I can see at this moment what we can report, like a testimonial. I could not see or read from 10 centimeter, 20 centimeter. I changed, as I said, my phone from normal to retina to be able to use a larger screen to see. This is 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago. We can provide the purchase bill for the units because I could not see. 8 days ago, 9 days ago, on Sunday, I started using the GANS water of CO2 on my own eyes because it's becoming critical. Sight was not easy. At night, it wasn't easy. Concentration, lack of seeing, and when you see, you frown, try to concentrate to see little words. You try to do all sorts of things. Now, if they put a camera, I can show you, I'm about maybe 10 meters away from my own book on the table. I can tell you where the D is, it says the origin of the universe. I can tell you the size, the shape, and everything else. And maybe now, 10 meters away, I can see the words, letters clearly on the book. This was impossible. I've been teaching in this room for nearly a year now. I had to go close to my book to be able to read, and I always said to myself, would there be a day that I cannot see my own writing anymore? Not anymore at this moment. I stood Giovanni in the office of the government. We were together in an office on Monday. We were in the office on Monday in the corridor, and I said, Giovanni, I can read from the other side. He said, I can see, but not really. This is there. But I could see the word better than he does. Yeah, he's laughing because he knows what I'm talking about. So I'm testing the gas water of CO2 directly. I put it in a bottle, a spray bottle, little spray bottles. I shake it every now and then, fill it up with the water from the tap, let it settle totally, and I just spray it directly into my eye. 2-3 spray, both eyes, and then I rub the water of the gas around my eyes, because on the side of the eye. When you receive your units, when you receive your drops, just don't drop it in the eye, because the change in the structure of the eyeball, as it's changed and create cataract or anything else, it has changed the construction and the structure of the eyelashes too. It has changed the structure of the muscles around the eye to accommodate the changes of the eyeball. So when you use it, rub the extra liquid around your face, around your eye, around the muscles. And what we have seen from the report from the doctors yesterday, the presence of the CO2 allows the generation possible of new tissues. That it means you can change, if there is any changes, it balances it. If in the need, it most probably builds it. So, but you see different changes. On, I can tell you day by day, as I reported before, on a Sunday night, the first time I used it, I had a very pressure on certain part of my brain. As I know the physiology of man, it was pressure on my writing, on the right side. I'm left-handed, so it showed my side has affected my writing. I had to write in different way that my side could adjust. So that was the first thing. The next day, as I reported to the doctors the following last Wednesday, not this Thursday, yesterday, that I had a start change in the strength of the tip of my tongue. Sometimes I still feel that. It's like that my eye has something in a direct way affects my taste or the operation of my tongue, because as body assumes that you're most probably going blind, it has to strengthen the other organs. How would you taste or understand the smell of the banana? Now you can't see. So a lot we can explain. So when you go through a degeneration of the eye or loss of the sight, body starts programming other part of the body to become stronger to replace it. I didn't see much changes. A little bit, you put it as a daily occurrence in your lifetime. But again, on Monday, Tuesday, especially yesterday morning, I felt a very heavy pressure in my eyeballs. It was just as they're coming out of the socket, but the pressure was internal. I couldn't put a finger on it, but it was there. It was something happening. It was just like a lot of muscles were moving to adjust themselves, but pulling and pushing. On Sunday, I noticed I couldn't read properly anymore. I was back into position. I said to Caroline, I can't read. I'm losing my sight again. Something's gone wrong. It worked for a few days. Then I realized, no, something has changed. I see the same light, but there is a problem. Because in past 10 years, 15 years with this eye degeneration, I've been pulling the muscles of my eye and closing my eyes. I used to put a little finger hole in front of my face that I could see from distance to read things. Now the change was different. I didn't have to, I had to open my eyes that I could read, because now I was going the reverse process. Where before I was frowning and looking at the light to be able to read, now I had to open. When I opened my eyes, I start seeing better. And my son said, Papa, you look frightened. I said, I can't believe it as well, but if this is good way, at least I can see you better now. And it was, it is, you go like this, because now you see different light. So it means the whole body is restructuring. And then I realized in that process that there is some weakness on the right side of the muscle of the right eye, because you could see feeling laziness, because most probably the other muscles have pulled, this has lost its strength. But now I feel it's coming to balance. I don't feel that laziness on one muscle. So this is how we're developing this technology. This is how I have used it. This is what is done to me. In less than 10 days, I can read near normal, but I have to adjust, because a lot of adjustment has been done. Very strange thing is, past 2 days, the food tastes different to me. Very different. Why? I don't know. But it tastes good. It tastes something which is desirable to eat, but it creates a lot of hunger. It creates enormous amount of hunger. But why does it do that? Has it changed the habit by not looking at the light in different way? Does it use a lot of energy to relocate and reorganize that energy shows itself as a hunger? Is the body reorganizing itself and needs a lot of mental and physical energy? Is it part of the process, how it is? I put my testimonial as part in the writing of the testimonial of using of CO2 for the eye. We've seen a testimonial of the use of the CO2 on the skin of the Dr. Nash in Ghana last week. He says, by using the GANS, the discoloring and the two-tone has gone and the hair is growing. Strange enough, we had the same report yesterday by one of the doctors in the doctor's teaching. So, does CO2, when you use it for the skin, changes the discoloration and the two-toning? It didn't make the skin of Dr. Nash into white. It changed to the tone of the rest of the skin. And where there was no hair, he says, look at the teaching of last Thursday, there is hair there growing too. Strange enough, we had the same report from one of the doctors yesterday in doctor's teaching. He has the discoloration, the blackness on his leg for how many, whatever, months or whatever. Now the discoloration is disappearing, all becoming white. The color of his skin. Or brown. And so, does this mean we can use this for the people who suffer so much with two-tone colors on their face and everything else? If you know some, ask them to join the trial, because we've seen two results. But there is a beautiful result another way. Listen to total story, not part of the story. In Dr. Nash's report last Thursday, he says, hair growing on my hand. On the results from yesterday from the doctor report, we received the same knowledge. Hairs are growing on the skin where there was no hair. Or more hair growing. Now, can we use CO2 gas water in conjunction with CH3 or on its own as a lotion for baldness? Yes, Giovanni says yes. I'm okay with a bald back. It's perfect for me. They say it's the sign of maturity. You know the old story. They say the ones with the full hair and black, they can, but they don't know how. The one with the white and bald, they know, but they can't. The best is the gray, silvery like me. We both can and we know. So, would it be possible that we change the transfer of use of the knowledge for all those men who spend hundreds of thousands of euros every year with two or three drops of the water of Gans to start growing the hair. Don't forget, go back on 6-7 years ago, one of our patients on a video said in respect to his into her husband, that the husband's hair was growing. We know this technology, it does that. But now we're receiving independent confirmation. This gentleman on a bike, some of you know who it is. We've seen growth of the hair in many cases in our trials. But now you've got an easy way, a public way. You missed it, I'm just repeating. So I'm not giving you a fairy tale. You missed it, go and listen. They tell you CO2 on the wound, how it disinfects wound, how tissues grow. You want to grow tissues, you have understand the skin cancer is created by change of environment in the salt layer of the body. And then it's like bone finds a way, it could be necessary that is the skin cancer a completion of the man trying to get the scales back like a fish, because we might need it. Now when you put the CO2, because you change the gravitational magnetic environment, then the change is no change and the skin cancer disappears, because you change the environment of it. Start deciphering the technology, the understanding of it in a full meaning. Start getting trust in what it can do. We have seen in trials here in Italy, if you use the GANS of CO2 for a skin fungus, if you have funguses on your skin from the pool or from whatever on the skin, applying the CO2 two, three times, tried every cortisone, every cream for 20 years, doesn't work. Two applications of CO2, there is no fungus, there is no infection. We see if you have a burn, if you have a mosquito bite, a spray of CO2 GANS water, not the GANS, never use the GANS itself, it releases the pain and very soon the bite is not even there. We've seen the application of the GANS water for malaria. We've seen the application of the GANS water, you can use it in toilets as disinfectant. We are using it in swimming pool, where by now the heat of summer, usually if you have 2-3 days, no chlorine in the water, worms glow like nothing. We don't see any worms, we don't see any chlorine. Start applying the technology. You travel to countries which is not hygienic. Carry with you your own made CO2 GANS. You get in, disinfect everything, voila. You've seen it is correct, because scientists from Ghana Atomic have shown you it's correct. You carry your own disinfectant. There it goes to Unilever. All their work of making detergents in the bin. That's why Jewish lobby doesn't like us. You have a child with diarrhea. You have a person with cancer. I explained this yesterday to the doctors, but it's a public knowledge, because we teach you, we have to explain it to you what it means. Go back on the teaching of the Keshe Foundation Innovation Center by one of our scientists. Couple of, where do I press? Fabio, I don't want to lose this. Can I have my white screen back? Go back on the teaching of Innovation Center. They made a very small video, 10, 15 minutes, a presentation with a full chart, measurement of the milliamps and everything else to show how the CO2, that's perfect, thank you very much. The CO2 in the water in a tube made the water from acidic to alkaline. We all seen it. Now, understand another part of research. international research, scientific research, especially the scientists who did it, has been put and committed so many times to prison because it did not fit the Unilever and the pharmaceutical. Now you can, they can put all of us in prison and the criminals will stay outside. It's a few of them we can take over, no problem. It's 7 billion of us, couple of hundred of them. The video is on Keshe Foundation website. When you add it, CO2 guns, the water change from 6.8 pH to 7.2 and the rest. Now, go back to the present research in the scientific world. Admire scientists, discredited by people very much like Red Circle because they were paid to do, and false accusation in courts. Alkaline water reduces cancer. So you go to every way to find, to drink, to make your food alkaline, because now we understand acid is heavy gravitational magnetic field, absorbs heavy energies, and that heavy energy needs to by the cancer, because cancer is the center point, needs heavy energy, so that's how it feeds each other. Now you take the gas of water, which scientifically is proven by a very simple big scientist of Keshe Foundation in Philippines, that it changes from acidic to alkaline. You drink this alkaline water, you change the strength of the stomach, lymph transfer energy from the intestine. The energy at the level which the cancer was used to, through the acidity of the strength, is not there, cannot feed it. It gives its energy out to a weaker plasma of the lymph, no cancer. The scientist who proved the connection between the alkaline and the acidity and the cancer, he is 100% correct. But victimized, prison and everything else by pharmaceutical, paid by the World Health Organization, which is supported by the Jewish lobby to stop it, because they cannot sell you chemotherapy for thousands of euros to the doctors to have nice mistresses, different part of the world, when they order you chemotherapy when you don't need it. Now you take the Gans water, drop a few in the water, you make the water alkaline, start drinking it, 2-3 spoons a day, you change the structure of the acidity of the stomach, the strength is not there, it cannot be supporting anything, you change the environment, weaker strength of the lymph, cha-chung, exactly the machine which Dr. Rodriguez uses to deplete energy from plasma of the cancer. So easy. Would you like to be a doctor? We call you a new plasma doctor? Do we start giving PhDs to single man in the space that he calls himself Dr. Nobody, because he's the last man standing? Do we need to carry titles, or do we need to understand the totality of the knowledge? Now you see how beautiful the technology is becoming. Now that we have opened the hand of the terrorists of the internet, the Red Circle and its paymasters, the kings. Just, you have a cancer today, you suffer from a cancer, try this. You change the alkaline. Part of it will help you, the other part we're getting scientists online to help you with the rest. Make yourself a patch of CO2, put it on the position of the cancer. You got a lung cancer, do the same. You got a brain tumor, make a patch with CO2, zinc oxide, and a little bit of calcium, because you need to create new cells that replace the cancer. you're done. You should be able to walk with it. Now you see how gorgeous, beautiful technology is. We have managed to shrug off the terrorists. Now we can show the beauty of it. Pardon? Which one?
The guy in the room, that
teacher. Yeah. No problem. You can make it yourself. Sure, please. Yes, no problem. Giovanni says we have the water downstairs made by the same man, and he shows his light and the fridge today. You got to realize it's very simple. You have food poisoning. You go to a restaurant, couple of drops. The thing is not solution to everything. The only thing you do, you change the environment of it, that the operation cannot go through. We've seen with the doctors, with salmonella soap. We cannot digest the soap, but inside your body, all the amino acid is there. All you do, you add a CO2, the way they add a CO2 to the soap, you energize it in different way, becomes alkaline, overtakes the salmonella and everything else. So, was the skin proposition, CO2 drinking in a moderate way is internal. And it changes everything because its energy gets absorbed. You have a condition with, let's say, anorexia. You don't need to do anything with anorexia. Anorexia is a psychological problem which does not allow energy to be absorbed and psychologically needs confirmation. All you need to do, CH3 plus zinc oxide with a little bit of CO2 gas water. Without them knowing, they start eating like pig. The only problem you have is a very big expense. A size 6 now to size 12 needs new clothing. And I don't mind having a fat child and a healthy child. Start understanding the beauty of the technology. That's what we said. We took our time. We took all the pressures, all the accusations, everything they could throw at us. All headed by the same man. The same terrorist, the same child abuser, the same murderer of 2 girls we know now. Because they were afraid they cannot satisfy their paymasters and afraid that they'll be found out. We found the 2, now it's open. Now we start showing you every beauty of the technology. Today I showed you how a cancer can be changed. Today I showed you, if you understand more, how you can travel. On the same board, just look. I made you man of space, and I made you the health masters, and I made you equal. According to your intelligence, you take what is on this board. The history of a man, the health of the man, and opening of the space to the man is on one writing. No more. You don't need more if you understood. You have to oppose it. If you have something to hide, or if you have done something which your paymasters would not do. I have one question to ask, and that's very simple. How much do we need to be at any of these positions? In a space travel, or in the space of our own physicality, to overcome what travels within us as germs and infections. One, we become the germ to travel. One is the germ inside us we need to control. But because you understand the totality of the knowledge, you can handle the both in one go. This is the knowledge of the universe. Not given to man, inappropriate, abused by those who were given partially, twice. In the coming weeks, I will open the history of mankind to the man that you can see. How man has done, and how you developed, and how you became generations, and how you traveled across this planet. And how different races were created. And if you have a doubt, we'll make it live presentation. you see your ancestors, how they became tribes and how you became cities and how you became part of the structure. If we show you and give you the bowl to drink in one go, you'll suffocate and you kill yourself, because you'll be ashamed of the one man has done to the man. Understand how you can use, understand how you can develop. If you understand even the shape of the egg, if you can repeat it and see what we saw with Jackie, now you understand you need no cookers and you can cook anything. Do we need to create a new system of the conversion of the plasma, that inside the plasma cook food, because the heat transfer of the magnetic field strength will cook what you want? Or do we still use fire? Understand the simplicity of the picture which was put on the table by Jackie. Open the egg, eat the egg. It's absorbed energy. You absorb energy by the fire into the egg to fry it or boil it. If the gaseous strength is enough to change the color or the hardness of the yolk into harder with different strength, now you have found yourself a new cooking way. Microwave now is magrav waves. Then we have entered a condition that we do not need to burn anything and we use the energy. And if we understand this process, it's very easy. Now we saw a cup with an egg, where the plasma energy transfer was here. Now we make a system that the energy transfer of the universe, when it comes to the liquid, it starts cooking without boiling. You receive and you cook exactly the way to the strength you want. Hard-boiled egg, soft-boiled eggs. Now you see the beauty of the technology and our patience to teach, and the burden we went under for it was worth it. No woods need to be burned, because now you can create gas difference layers that absorbs energy from around, and if you put this in it, will give you a boiling at 210 degrees. If you put this in it, will give a cooking at 30 degrees. This is what gradually all of you will add. Your names will become the names of the future, because we will not talk about the engines and the others, and we don't talk about Mr. Watt, and we don't talk about horsepower. We talk about Alex Power System. We talk about Benjamin Soap. As I said, we talk about every one of you are the new scientists of the new generation of the plasma magnet system. You teach us, we show it. We are open, we display it. You have all the Keshe Foundations around the world to share knowledge in your own language. Any questions?
Thank you, Mr. Keshe. If there's any viewers that have a particular question, they can raise their hand. I can make you into a panelist. There are a couple of people that have already done so. There's, let me see here. One that, oh, there he's back again, I think. Gladstone, is that the...
Gladstone, yes. Is that the gentleman with the antenna on his roof in Australia, am I correct?
Yes, I believe so, and he wanted
Has the house flown yet, or have you demolished the ceiling?
No, Mr. Keshe, good evening, Mr. Keshe, and the team, and everybody. No, I haven't flown yet, I'm still on the Earth.
That's good. So plasma technology is safe.
Yes, I'm working on it.
Yes, please share knowledge with us.
Okay, you should be able to see on my Facebook site, I've actually linked the coils
up. You know, I don't go on the Facebook, so I can't share it. So you have to show us.
Don't know how I can show you.
What would you like to show in particular on your Facebook? I could pick out the pictures maybe, or if you can.
Yeah, it's just the coil hanging from the roof.
Fabio, could we have the screen share?
Okay.
Is that the one you mean?
Yes, it is, yes. That's a picture of the coils. I've got a number of items within the coils. They're all linked together in series. And as you advised, the mechanical side of the coil must be linked to the roof, and the gravitational to an entire antennae externally. Within the coils, the red ball that you see has got GANs in it. And I've got crystals and other items within the middle of the actual coils. What I've noticed over the last couple of weeks is really calming effects within the house. There is a slight frequency that I've noticed, and my wife has noticed as well. I'm not sure how that is affecting or where it's coming from as such. So I was just, within that picture as well, I've got a plastic ball at the bottom of the coils, which is full of CO2 GANs. Might be in another photo. But yeah, that's the system. And 2 weeks in, everything seems quite calm. I was just wondering whether you could give some advice on whether I've got the system set up correct.
I don't know why you said it. You can't be wrong. And I keep on saying none of us is wrong. You have to find the work and the parameters of the effect of the what you built.
Okay.
If you transfer these sideways and make it in a column and put different GANs in between it, then you can do the transportation of the emotion from the house to what you want and put on the outer ring copper zinc oxide coils. And then you find what I call a hippie land, most probably. You know, everybody will be happy and jolly.
Okay.
So we learn from you. You tell what you observing. You know your family. You know the environment you live in.
Okay.
Is it the placebo effect because there is something else, or there is a reality to it that is? So we make a happy change and we hang it the way we do, like other things in the house, that this thing will bring happiness in the house. Or we don't become superstitious, but we understand the science behind it.
Yes.
Yeah, so you made a happy change like a hippie time, so why not? Do we need rock and roll? I will be happy with just a bit hanging on the ceiling. Is that the future of the happiness, what you show us? Or shall we call it the Gladstone happiness ring?
Okay.
So bring the knowledge. It's beautiful what you've done. We thank you for it. We don't need any measurements. Happiness is measured by Nepal government only, and it's a very happy nation. But let us know more in what it does and what does it mean, the happiness to you.
Okay, Mr. Keshe, yeah, thanks very much for that.
Thank you indeed. What's this jar on the table?
That jar has got a CO2, GAN CO2 water in.
Uh-huh.
And I was just trying to involve, there's this plastic ball below as well that has got CO2 GANs water in as well, so that's at the bottom of the coil. So, and the cable you can see is going to the antennae externally. So I'm trying to involve a number of sort of GANs within the system.
Maybe add zinc oxide to it and see how it comes.
Okay, zinc oxide.
Yeah, because that touches the emotion. Maybe you're creating a field strength around that creates it, or it needs it for that connection, and then see if you all be happy running around the house.
Okay.
This we've seen this. This what you talk about antenna. We were talking in the medical section the other day that a lot of people suffer from these masks and what you call waves from the mobile phones and everything else.
Yes.
We have tested a lot of things in time. We maybe found one or two solutions of it, not all of it. Now, for example, maybe by use of these antennas, you can change the reception of these by the body of the people. Maybe they don't have any more problem with living in the house. It's a lot of usage if you understand what you started, because I've done a lot of work in this field. If you see the change, ask people, you know, people who get affected by the microwaves or by the antennas or whatever, make a chain or two and give it to them and say, test it to see if they can live in their rooms without the pain. They live a very painful life, these people.
Okay.
It affects them.
Just one more question, Mr. Keshe. I've got an analog aerial on the roof. It's a traditional sort of TV aerial. It's analog. Could I use that as an antennae, or because it's aluminium?
Why not? It's a good suggestion. Let everyone nanocode their antenna around the world.
So with the aluminium,
I don't know what you're going to receive, huh? It becomes a good absorber. You might be better. Maybe it becomes part of your energy supply as well.
Okay, so I've got to nanocode the aerial itself, and then that'll be the receiver. Yeah.
Yeah. That becomes, and make sure everything to your line is nano-coated. I see these as so many times what you just suggested, I've gone through my head. Because in Italy, when you pass a house, there's about 200 of them sticking on top of each house, each apartment block. Everyone has to have their own two or three of them. It's like everybody's trying to listen to God somehow, and the God, it comes from one direction.
Yes.
So if you nano-coat them, or so many times I think, the whole building can be supplied with energy from the environment without any power supply.
Okay.
So you understand? Because in time, you receive all kinds of energies. You just need to convert it. We've done an aerial conversion years ago, and it works beautifully for energy. You know, the cars with the antenna which gets pulled up, not the new glass version which is embedded.
Yeah.
We tried on those, and it works wonders in the car.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Keshe and the team.
Let us know when you become a happy house.
Okay, will do. Thank
well,
you.
Well, it'll be interesting. Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Do you observe the environment in respect to the birds, and anything has changed in fauna or flora? Or you haven't noticed? You haven't taken note of them?
It's coming to winter in New Zealand where I'm living, so I haven't been observing that, but I will. I'll keep an eye on that and make notes.
Please. It'll be nice to see, compared to last year, if you see more birds, less birds.
Okay.
Whatever. Because it's very strange you bring in this up. Let me tell you something else. Here in where we live, 4 or 5 weeks ago, 3 or 4 weeks ago, we were collecting forever mosquitoes and bees and butterflies and every other insect which was flying around the garden in the pool.
Okay, yeah.
We were going around with these nets collecting literally hundreds, thousands of these every day. About 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, I emptied about 4, maybe more, 6 liters of a specific GANS water I made into the pool.
Okay.
Now we don't see a single fly on the same pool suddenly. It has been the worst storms around us in past 2 weeks. We were in Rome, we came back and they told us, it's on the news on the in the Italian channel television, that snow is like a hail of stones, like a snow on the street. Trees blowing everywhere. I can't find a single dust on the surface of my pool. There is not a leaf on it to collect it. I was looking at it this morning, I said, this is impossible. Where are they going? They were there up to now and there are none. Yes, there is one thing on my pool, is a plastic bag which is flown from somewhere in the storm. That's the only thing I can see.
Okay.
So these things affect the environment. And then the Caroline was testing something very interesting. She mixed a part of the CO2 gas water with a little bit of mosquito spray and spraying it around the house, on the just washing the floor and the walls with it yesterday.
Yes.
And last night we just saw only one mosquito, where before we were forever covered with mosquito spray and everything else.
Okay. There is one funny thing that's happened to our windows, and it's the windows that's facing north. For some strange reason, it's just become dirty, as if it's like attracting kind of some kind of particulates.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure whether that's got anything to do with, you know, the way the graph system in the roof, but the whole front of the house, all the windows, the wind glass is kind of speckled and kind of dirty, as if it's collecting, attracting something.
Just get some CO2 gas and water off it, yeah, and just wash the windows with it and see, yeah, if it comes back. It's a very good deterrent. It's a very good, not deterrent, but saying change of environment.
Okay.
We're getting a lot of reports. People are testing CO2 in conditions and things that is not even imaginable. And they see results, because for them it was something they wanted to do. There is, okay, no limitation in the science, but just remember, don't use certain kind of gas that affects our body and our environment, because we are amino acid based.
Okay.
This is beautiful. Thank you very much.
Thank
what's
you,
this bag? Is this what's this bag, BC?
Well, in regards to CO2 that you're just speaking of, this is a picture from Stanley. Maybe he can speak about it. He says, hello, Rick, can I show something to Mr. Keshe about interesting CO2 pads? I received, yeah, two cases where people who are using the CO2 pads, they're seeing black dots on the surface of the pads. They would like to know what causes this coloration.
Is it on the tissue or outside?
We've seen this before. I believe it's on the inside, on the tissue, but inside the plastic.
Yeah, all you need to do is just add a drop of copper oxide into it. We've seen these black spots. These are bacteria or viruses which are depleted from the energy they've grown, but they deplete, and they're just, Canadian scientists showed us the black spots on the screen. All you need to do is just to add, when you make these tissues, just out of, let's say, a liter of gas of CO2 or CH3, add one drop or two drops of gas of copper oxide. Copper oxide energy is different, so that doesn't allow life level to exist inside it.
Okay, is it also possible that some people seem to think, at least, that the pads are pulling the poisons or toxins out of their body and getting
quite possible
into the pads
quite
themselves?
Possible. Quite possible. We got to learn, we got to analyze, as I said to the Ghanaian scientists last week, can you analyze the back of the leftover, that we know what it is? Is it bacteria or is it the energy package which is God itself? You see, they are homogeneous in size. Mm-hmm. Then there is a pattern to it. You've got to find out what the pattern is.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's common in older days to use what was called a poultice, and it might be an Epsom salt poultice or other kinds of salts or whatever, to draw out a poison or, for example, some sort of splinter or a thorn in the body that gets infected. You can put a poultice over it, which is a cloth essentially that's soaked in the salty liquid set on top of a cloth, and that tends to draw out the toxin.
In Europe, they used to use it very commonly. Now you don't see that much. It's used armies.
That's right. The way I understand it.
Oil and you extract everything out.
They used to be used in the war before they came up with antibiotics, and that took over from using the poultices. But the poultices were so much simpler, and for me personally, I have experience with this where I had an infection in my knee from a piece of metal that had gotten stuck in my knee, just a tiny piece. But over a few weeks, it swelled up, and I went to the hospital, and the doctor or nurse said that if it got any, you know, this is very serious. It's a, you know, blood poisoning situation. And they wanted to put me in the hospital bed immediately with IV antibiotics for a week before they would even treat it or try to remove what's in there. And I started sweating at the thought of being in a hospital bed with this needle stuck in my arm for a week. I asked them, how can I get out of this? I do not want to subject myself to this. And they said, well, you'll have to sign this release saying, you know, that we're not responsible should, you know, you're risking losing your leg here and possibly your life and so on. I was pretty scared, but I left and went home and went to my wife's doctor, who was both a chiropractor and a naturopath, and he suggested this Epsom salt poultice. And he told me in 30 seconds in the waiting room, didn't even have to see him as an appointment, what to do. And within 2 days of this poultice that he described to me, all the infection was gone, and whatever was in there was pulled out, gone, and I've had no trouble with it since. And before that 2 days, I could barely walk and so on. So it's amazing some of that old technology, how it works. And I think that the CO2 pads work in a similar manner in the way they pull those fields out and withdraw that infection or that pain, depending on how they get used.
We're coming to the summer season in Northern Hemisphere, and we're getting a lot of people who are using the CO2 gas on the skin against sunburn. And they are reporting huge, huge changes. We see it on the children when you rub the CO2 on their faces or whatever for sunburn, or the people who've been sunburned with a bad sunburn, they just put the CO2 on. Even the skin comes off, but there is no scars and no damage. So the application of the new plasma is very different. Does it do what we've been saying, that the three layers, now you add a fourth layer on top, becomes the fifth layer because the burn skin is in the middle. The body just rejects it under the plasmatic condition without bleeding, because now it works its own system. Now you get a skin. There is a picture somewhere on the internet, the guy literally has got his own skin in his hand, more or less, getting it out without any bleeding. Because now we create a new layer with a CO2 that the body understands is on the same strength, and except lets the skin layer to go away and without the bleeding, the way we reject the skin so much. We've done this with the tumors in the cancer of the breast. So we need to understand more this, how and the way the energy transferred, how much of it that we can share knowledge, all of us, that we can benefit by it.
Okay, but, well, Sylvester,
it's amazing.
Sylvester mentions he has other pictures and more to say about that as well. Sylvester, can you, also Francois mentions, Francois Flibot, he has a few patches with these spots on it to show as well. So if we want to have a look at those. Hello?
Yes, hello. Hello, Rick. Thank you so much. This is Sylvester. The pictures I sent it to you, Rick, and you're showing right now is coming from Mr. Szabo from Hungary. And he made these pictures about the CO2 patches, and he used the same type of CO2 patch on himself and his wife. And what is very interesting is coming from the same CO2 source, the same production of CO2, but his wife's CO2 patches do not show any dots on it. But his CO2 patches showed in both sides. And what's interesting, 1.5 years ago, he was also diagnosed with mold allergy. So his question was, maybe he's have to do something with his allergy. And there's also another gentleman, he showed a video, Facebook video, with the same phenomenon. On his patch, it's only one side showed these type of dots. And I really appreciate Mr. Cash to explain that the copper oxide will be very helpful. So I will transfer these information to Mr. Tok. So this is the video.
If the patches still persist and are there, we have to find out what they are. Are they transfer? Yeah. Are we? Let's put this with Sylvester. Are we creating like cancers on the patches? We're taking the cancer out of the body into the patch.
I think the second was the feeling of these people, because actually the gentleman who's showing right now in the video. This gentleman have a great effort on his body. He's an oversized person, probably a problems of some internal health issues and etc. But he used these patches on his left cavity pain, and the pain was relieved immediately. And he also used and cured himself on his shoulder pain. The shoulder pain was also disappeared. But surprisingly, he find these dots on it. I can request the two gentlemen to ship these patches to you, Mr. Cash, so, or any laboratory you refer, and they can do further analysis on it.
Let me let you know, because the positions we can send it to, we prefer not to go public. We see the hooligans of the internet with their swamp around it.
Exactly.
So it can be done. We can test it. We have our facilities. Now Cash Foundation has facilities to do a lot of work. A lot of work, fully financed by the governments and the institutes. Yes, why not? Do we have any more to share?
Well, it's Jay McDougall mentions in the chat, which might be interesting, that moles can be seen under UV light, that'd be ultraviolet light. It would be good to see if the black spots which are on the patch reflects the mole map on the person under a UV lamp to see whether it's a similar pattern under an ultraviolet Rick. Lamp.
Very interesting, very interesting. Maybe why not?
Mr. Cash, but sometimes that...
Excuse me, do you mind introducing yourself? We don't know you at all.
My name is Armin.
From California.
From California.
Yes, Mr. Armin. We call him Master Armin. He's the master of the Keshe Foundation. Yes, Master Armin.
If you seal it properly, it will never happen. If you vacuum seal it and seal it, it will never go black. I had few patches which I left it open. Sometimes, you know, air goes in. Yes, then you can see the black spots.
But if you then what happened to the black spots?
Huh?
And then what happened with the black spots?
It's like a fungus. It's because
You know, Armand, not everyone who's got the mustache is your uncle, huh? Not just because it's black as microbes. We've got to find out.
No, I've seen it that, you know, these things is happening when the patches are not sealed properly. But if you vacuum pack, they will never go black.
It's okay. We have Renan online. They have 6,000 of these in Philippines being distributed. Have you noticed anything like this in Philippines, Renan? Is Renan online?
I can show you these patches.
Yes, please. We don't see something. It's missing on this the screen at the moment. Rick, you have to stop sharing, please.
Okay.
Give me a minute.
Arman, are you flying yet?
1 minute. How can I share my camera?
You already shared. We are there with camera. There's a camera on the left-hand side of the Zoom. It says camera. Okay. You got to press that one.
Start video, Armin.
Yeah, yeah.
And select the right source video.
It's just showing red right now.
It's not showing here.
Okay. Yeah. Hello, Armand. Yes?
It's a vacuum packed.
Yeah. And it's black. It's full of fungus.
No. This is new type of patches.
Ah.
But what I'm saying, if you vacuum pack, this will never go back.
Yeah, we are not interested in your vacuum pack. Go on your clever what you just showed us. Go back. We would like to see your new patch.
Yeah.
Explain.
And this one.
Explain what's what. How did you make that one and what is the other one? And what are you made it for?
I made it for lung cancer.
Ah, is that for that lady?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And Mr. Keshe, this one is a zinc.
Ah, okay. Is it double core?
No. Yeah, it's a double core.
Well, okay. You see, he's a master of the Keshe Foundation. He comes up with the things. It's beautiful. No wonder you're a master. So what do you do with it, Armin? Explain. You show it, you teach it. I'm not there in a few weeks' time to teach. Now you got to teach.
I have CO2 and zinc oxide water in this one, and the same in here.
And the coil is both the GANs. Can you explain? What should I ask you a question? You're the teacher. Explain to us.
This is GANs water.
Yes, but tell us what you've done. We are listening.
I created a flow which comes from here and exits from this side.
So these two patches you are using, one in the front and one in the back.
Yes, like a magnet.
Mm-hmm.
This is a full magnet and this is a ring magnet.
That is all nano coated.
Yes, all nano coated. Even the plastic is nano-coated.
So the two Magrav system, one is a flat and one is ring, but it still have a CO2, which affects the energy conversion of the conductivity. And then you have a zinc to touch the emotion because it's the lung.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Now you should explain this, not me.
And I have one more tool, Mr. Kish. This is a neuberizer.
Yes.
And I nano coat this component inside, and it gives a very tiny mist of what I'm planning to do, put CO2 in it that they can breathe.
You're using the plasma vapor?
Yes.
I hear it works very good on the lungs. Am I correct?
Yes, it works very good on lungs, Mr. K.
And it stops you coughing too?
Yes.
Is it the one you use like a shisha?
Not this one. I use the shisha and it helped me a lot. Mornings I smoke a lot,
Would you like to give us your testimony now that you spoke about it?
I use 4 days and I don't cough in the morning at all.
Aaron used to cough heavily. When he used to be here, we could hear him as well sometimes.
No, morning. Well, yeah.
Can you show us your breathing system, your shishe?
Okay.
He sent me the picture this morning and said, hey, it looks a very nice shishe. It looks what we call a hubble bubble, but it's good for his lung. Yeah. That's Armin's hubble bubble or shishe. Explain to us what's in there, please.
You just breathe the air, it passes through the water.
And what's in the water?
It's CO2 and zinc.
Oxide liquid gans.
Liquid gans.
Liquid plasma.
Yes.
And how does it feel your breathing?
Very normal, Mr. Keshe.
Very normal. Can we go for a marathon? You can run?
I did not try it, but I hope so.
Yes, yeah. Sir. You got use anything with the gas that in between 7 to 14 days. It's because it's plasmatic, it imprints very fast on the it balances the energy field flow from RNA to DNA, and it becomes permanent because it's balanced. You don't become viruses, but it's not attached, it will not be there. Mm-hmm. But how does it feel not to cough in the morning?
Very nice. You wake up. As you
are, you still, are you still smoking about 20 packs a day?
No, stop. 2 packs, that's
all. Has it changed the taste in your mouth with this inhaling?
No, actually, it didn't change anything in my mouth. Still, I have the same taste. But I eat a lot.
Hey! Are we going to see super-sized Armin very soon? Do we have to change the doors at the foundation? You won't get in through. So what else do you, does it feel any pain in your lungs, any expansion?
I feel very good when I breathe. Actually, I feel normal. I don't wake up, with cough. And cough, it takes like 10, 15 minutes, I think, until you overcome.
Maybe this is a condition of pre-flight. And it's Armin, have you fried yet? But would it change in what else you feel? Do you feel a change in your composure, in your sitting or standing?
No, I didn't check that. I didn't pay attention.
Ask Her Majesty. They observe because you don't see it yourself. People will see you because you change your breathing, your capacity changes. When your lung collapses, you tend to bend forward or your shoulder goes down. When we've seen this in many trials, that when you have a better relaxed breathing, after about 3-4 weeks, your composure changes as well. You open up because you breathe air totally different. Let us know if you still carry on smoking. That'll be very interesting.
Thank you, Mr. But what I will ask, do I need to add CH3 for her or no?
No, because CH3 increases the growth. Okay. That's the last thing you want to do.
Okay.
Yeah, you have to use a CO2 and zinc oxide. Don't use copper oxide so much for the lung. If your breathing is, you see the problem I explained in other teachings is that when you use these systems for the lung, for breathing, what you do is not the CO2 that creates a condition. The science behind it is very simple. When you have the lungs moving and functioning with the cancer or whatever, or with your breathing, they have to convert the energy into a system that becomes like a hydrogen, that the energy, I explained this very recently, I don't know if which teachings it was, but I'll repeat it here because, can I have my screen back? Then we can explain it very easy to understand. When you use these systems and why it brings the change, the science behind it is very simple. The science behind it is, when you take the oxygen, or not the oxygen, when you breathe in your lungs, you bring air with the nitrogen and with the other gases into your lung. And then the tunnels, the veins of the lung narrows as much as possible. In your stomach, you have acids and others to convert the food in that place. To convert the food, how come I don't take colors? To convert the food from matter state to a nano state to a gas state, that when it goes in your intestine, it becomes plasmatic, transfers the energy through the wall of the intestine into your limb. The reason we have liquid in our lungs is the same process. The liquid is another caustic combination converting the gases into a nano, into the GANS, and then as they go to the last bit, they transfer the energy to the blood cells. So, in fact, a lung is a digestion system, conversion system, the same as the stomach. The stomach is for the solid and liquid, lung is for the air. Because man was created out of the air of this environment first. We are amino acid. Amino acid is the combination of the gases of oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, and hydrogen, which is in the environment of this planet. And plus, if we look in some of the amino acids, there are other gases attached to as well, which man has never looked into, but maybe it's time to do. So when you breathe air in, you bring it into the digestion system of the salt of the lung, to convert it to a gas, to a plasmatic condition, to the field, and then it absorbs, it transfers energy out. And as we have said many times, nitrogen is a centralizer which releases energy at the rate of conversion. So you have a oxygen which gives its energy for conversion. What comes out of it is the balance of carbon, or what you call CO2, because then it attaches itself to its own creator, and we say we inhale CO2. The process is an instant in the lung of the man. So when you breathe, when you have a problem with the physical structure of the lung, like tumors or whatever, COPD or whatever, when you breathe air through the already produced GANS system, in a way what you do is very simple. Here, instead of converting your energy in the lung, the energy conversion is already done as a GANS vapor, so when it comes, immediately is absorbed by the lung. So, in being absorbed, it gives a relaxing time for the lung to recover, because now the lung veins do not need to expand and shrink. So, the energy is already, you've taken your lung. These systems, these breathing systems which you make with the GANS, is in fact, it's like the, what do you call it, the mechanical heart they make, the mechanical lungs they make to help you. These are those systems. I've used this effectively many years. So what you do, instead of breathing, converting in your lung, you bring the air with already loaded, the same as the soap where you added the CO2 to. Now you load the oxygen or the carbon or a nitrogen which comes from the air, you add it into it. So it's loaded. When it comes, but it doesn't need to do the conversion because it already received extra energy, you change the environment of the cell and you see the body has time to heal, to recover and transfer energy out. When you put the two pads inside out on either side, is again, is you can't do what you do with the air, where in the mechanical system you connected the nano-coated material from one patch to another. Here, as we've seen with the scientific, with the doctors, they tell you he's got the two pads, he used the air, the patch dictates where I want the energy to be conserved. Most probably, you can walk away, if it's not too late, with the lung cancer. But you cannot use these patches. You need armor to make a patch for the body, because the cancer conversion could be in other lymphs which are imbalanced, the same as the lymph of the lung. You understand? So you have to use a full body system for every cancer, not just because you see it in the lung. Because if you don't process it properly, in 6 months time it'll be in liver, or it's already in the liver, it shows itself in liver in 6 months time. But the process when you breathe the lymph, the CO2, gas, water from it, as the air goes through it, it carries exactly like the soap. They put an Cl or whatever they did with CO2, I mean, so it killed the germs, because the energy was low, germ had to give energy to it. Here you have the air, it's additional energy, so the body doesn't need to absorb or convert the gas so much. Then you find out the body has time to relax because it received its energy, and then it has a time to it has a time to heal, it has a time to repair. The energy was used for pressurizing the lung to absorb the energy of it for the blood. Now it uses that energy, because it's receiving it from inhaling of the new energized gas, for healing itself, and then it goes. I was explaining this to a doctor very recently. These breathing systems are like mechanical hearts, you know. It's become, if you can afford it, nowadays if you have a heart problem, certain heart problems, they disconnect your heart and connect it to a mechanical system for 6 months or a year. Your heart still works in conjunction with the mechanical heart, but because there is not much pressure on it, it allows it to recover from its damages, and then they take the system away and you start working perfectly as before. These breathing systems are the same as those, but it's a natural process. I give you a tip. A lot of people who have heart problem, a lot of people, even certain type of blockage in the vein. Please do not try this without the supervision of a doctor who is part of the Keshe Foundation knowledge, understands and can support it. This is for the doctors who work with us, they listen to this program. Our Chinese doctors in the Chinese team in China, this is directed to you, because I know you work on that way. If you make ratio 8 CO2, 6 CO2, 3 CH3, 1 CuO. Ratio is important. Ratio is CO2, 6, CuO2, 1, if you want a full effect, CH3, 3. If you use this ratio and put this patch on, you will get physical repair. But most of the heart problems has a psychological, because the heart is the feeder of the psychological part of the body of the man. You can do a very simple. You do CO2 5, CH3 2, COU2 1, and you add zinc oxide 1. This is for the doctors, please, if you're not a doctor, because if you use it, you feel the changed palpation different, and you have to be a doctor to be able to control it. We teach everyone on this platform, what's got not to do with you, do not try. So If you're a doctor, you're looking for brain blockage, you're looking for support of the heart valve to replace, or you want to do it, is very much this kind of combination. CO2 is a cross formation information between the blood, and CO2, CuO is building of the muscles. You have to change the ratio according to what you need. CH3 is to energize the blood, that the body does not look for the energy to put pressure on the lungs to bring energies for itself. It supports itself in that point. And then, because body, the blood of the man is the supporter of his emotion for his body works, you have to add the zinc to support the energy of the emotion. You'll find out heart recoveries in 14 to 21 days, up to 4 weeks. The change, but you have to get the combination right, and you have to understand the condition of your patients correctly to be able to do this. There is no need for open heart surgeries, for blood clot, or blockages of the main arteries. If you develop a patch in the teaching with the doctors, if you remind me, I can teach you how to do it. You can actually release and open the arteries very, very softly with this process, without the need for open heart surgeries, transfer of the blood vessels. It's a special technique. I'll teach you what to do, because it's very dangerous. If it's not known, do not touch it, but we expand on the knowledge. Doctors have to understand how they can help themselves. If you do this, if you are not knowledgeable and you're not a doctor, if you put these patches on your heart, you feel a pressure. Means it's interacting with you, do not touch. Because these are powerful systems, and you can put a patch in the front, patch in the back, and within 6-8 weeks, there is no need for any kind of heart surgery at all. In certain cases, where it's diagnosed properly, when it's handled properly, and you can see your patient walking away. If you change the combination in a slightly different way, it's good for where the heart valve has collapsed or damaged. You rebuild the heart valve directly while it's in the heart working without operating anything else. Then this needs a special combination. We don't teach this thing in public, but it's good for the doctors sitting in the background to remind me in the doctor's teaching and teach you, if you are not a doctor, do not touch. You can put yourself and the others at risk, because this is very, very, very delicate. I use it. I'm fully aware of the knowledge in how to use it, and you can do wonders with this kind of things, which can be done. You can use this in conjunction with the breathing system to support the lung, that it doesn't take pressure. You give the lung a rest. You give a lung a rest. In having the rest, it allows the development of what it needs, or repair of what it needs. Because at the end of the day, what is created in the lung is to feed the energy into the physicality of the body, and that's what the lung does. It's here to operate with the heart. So in certain approach, with a mixture of the breathing, you support the energy delivery to the heart, you give a heart a rest exactly like a lung, and then you allow a repair. It has to be done by physicians. If you are not, please, I've seen a lot of stupidity from a lot of people making whatever. This is not a child play. So we see the first signs, the first approaches of how we can walk away from all tens of hundreds of thousands of dollars and euros open heart surgeries with less than 20 cents. But it has to be done by the physician. If you are not, you stand responsible for the soul which you had.
Mr. Keshe, we've got Renan on here that can give us a report about the whether he's getting any of the black spots with his patches that he uses.
Please, go ahead.
Hello, Mr. Keshe.
Hello, Mr. Renan. I wanted to talk with you yesterday, today. We need to talk after we finish. It's something important.
Okay, sir. About the
It's to do with the doctor's teaching yesterday. I need you to do a couple of tests, very urgent.
Okay, sir.
Okay, carry on.
So about the patches, what we have been producing here, I only found the patches on the items that are being kept for a long time. So these white black spots can be seen only for, with about 100 patches, I can see only at least occurrence of one. So it's correct. I think it's there's a leakage. Most of the patches I've seen, there are moist coming out from it and some are open. So possibly the contamination, or there's a contamination from that patches. But also, I have kept some patches that I reuse every time and reuse and just kept it inside in my bag. I personally use, and it's just with me always. So sometimes when I reuse it, there's already some black spots as well. So I think it's just part of a it's a growth. I don't know what's the growth yet. We're gonna check it in the microscope. But there's a growth in the tissue that we are using. So it's part of the, maybe part of the tissue, which is maybe there's a growth of microbes or anything in that when you use the patch. So it's better to really seal it, because once using the other patches that are very sealed and they don't get dry for a long time, and with a harder or more durable containers, you find it no contaminations on it. I think the CO2 with the tissue paper inside or the napkin creates a good environment to grow certain elements when they are attracted to it, because it's energy. So you need to seal it properly and handle with care in making these patches. That's what our observations here. But when it dries up, also we have observations, even though it is fully sealed, sometimes it dries up when it's exposed directly under the sun, and the plastic patches bloats with gas in there. It still is effective in a way that the liquid GANS or the liquid plasma has transformed to vapor, and it has also a soothing effect on pains as well. So that was also been discovered with very sealed plastic patches, then they evaporated. So that's one thing. And we also tried, for those who are already been using these patches, to reuse them if they have leakages. We just we repack and wet them again with CO2 liquid GANS, liquid plasma, and then it can be reused again. So, which is for you, for yourself, when you want to recycle it, if you have you don't have any available much of the patches. So that's what we're using for the patches as well. So that's my observation.
Renan, you've distributed something like thousands of these in Philippines.
Yes, sir. We have already distributed different outreach activities.
Pardon?
We have distributed every time we have the outreach activities in the slum areas. We give them to them, and as well as they already know how to make them. So right now, in different two areas in our place are already producing these patches for giving in their neighbor. So we're working in a community service wherein these are the living in slums, so they have no permanent home. So we just teach them how to make pens and patches, and now they are being able to liberate themselves from all of the medicines that government doctors are, that they are having problem every time.
Are you going back and pick up some testimonial data in how it works with these people now is in a mass use?
Yes, sir. We have in our language testimonials, and we're also getting the from the youth, mostly youth and their parents are using them. So we're gonna gather the one, but most of them are, we have videos, telling what happened and everything, but it's in our dialect. We can put on, we can put as interpretation if we can use that those videos for them are in English subtitles so that you can understand. So we can gather them because it's been working for them for already 2 months. So we in that place we tested it 2 months ago and we returned, and that they have testimonies. That's why people were coming in there with us, and they were also asking other barangays in the area to work or to collaborate in this medical mission. So we can get that information, Mr. Cash. Those testimonies.
Mr. Brennan, can I ask you a question, please?
Yes, sir.
One of the things will be interesting, what we discussed, I asked you, were not there. Maybe you can ask your team to do another beautiful job what you did last time. You showed the use of the GANs in creating what you call alkaline water. Could you ask your team or the same group if they can do now a test on the liquid GANs, that when we put the GANs of the CO2, the water of the GANs into the water, how does it change it? Does it still make it alkaline? We need a proof of this scientifically. You've done a very good theta test with a machine, with a meter. Could you test that and let us know next week?
Yes, sir. That is what we are verifying right now. We had already set it up, as you were mentioning last week during the also in the doctor's meeting. So we're already doing the CO2 GANs drops. So we're gonna show you some data as we calibrate the pH meter. So we're doing we have already pH meters here as well, so we can really say what's the pH level. So they have different configurations, and we utilize different liquid GANs, and we will see what are the variations of different liquid GANs. We can show it, sir.
Can it be done by next week?
Yes, sir. It can be done by next week, sir.
Could we show it in the doctors, because we were discussing it as you were there yesterday?
Yes, sir.
We can show it, and then next week we show it in the public teaching. The other thing it would have been interesting to know is that if you have cases where, like this liquid GANs water on the patch, in breathing and after breathing, when you can collect the saliva, whatever, and you can add it to the water to see if that has changed the alkalineness of the, the saliva.
Okay, so we want to see using the breathing cups or the breathing straws, we will investigate the alkalinity or the pH level of the saliva of the person.
Yeah, please. Because then it gives us another insight into the knowledge. Thank you very much. Thanks. Is there anything new you want to share with us from Innovation Center?
Right now, sir, it's not yet, because it's still for the future, as you have said.
Thank you very much indeed. Thanks for your help, Leonard.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you indeed. Is there anything else, any more knowledge we can share, or shall we call it the day for today? We became the man of one hour. Oh, this is from South America again. It sounds like it. Rick, can we get this silence? Somebody's opened the microphone. As I said, today we became the man of a space. Now we learn the first basis for transportation of the man to fit any part of the universe, and for him to be able to travel. At this moment, this is very far-fetched, because it's the same as when we spoke about the GANs and nanomaterials 2-3 years ago. But that now that we have the man of knowledge and science and government behind us, maybe it's time to start developing the true space technology, because these machines of the transportation can be used in conjunction with a star formation or deep space travel, where you don't need to send a craft to excursion, you deliver at a point of excursion. You don't this way need to cross atmospheric barriers or what you call the Coulomb barriers of the planet. This way of delivery has huge application implication in the space where you can deliver yourself within the center of the planetary system or a stars or a galaxy without ever passing the matter state of it or interaction of the fields of it. Because when you travel at the rate of the conversion till you arrive at the destination point. It's very much when you're an envelope, does not matter if the truck carries you, a plane carries you, or you're sent by jumbo jet. In what you're sent is irrelevant. What you cross, if you cross the sea, the storm, the road, or a mountain, or you go through a tunnel, does not change what's in the envelope or the structure of the envelope. Now, we enter that condition. On the other hand, we've seen how the new technology can be used for conversion of the health, because these are very important, because they change the emotion and the physical imbalance for the whole rest of the body. Do we walk in and walk out in a few times without any cancer, without Alzheimer's, without the arm and the leg missing, which is blown up by a bomb built hundreds of years ago by man through his misconduct? Would the landmines deter us from losing an arm and a leg because somebody made money out of it? 1500 years ago was left on the ground, we didn't see it. We can walk into these cabins and build what has been missing, because in RNA there should be a piece called here, a toe, which is blown up. We are entering the real world of the creation of the plasma and its application. It's for us to decide how we take the humanity this time. Do we take man to the point which is was the animalness and killing and murdering, or do we go the path of universe, a peaceful culture, peaceful race that we can join to enjoy the universe than a few patches of the land on this planet? This is our task. This is where we stand. With these teachings, we bring man on a point of decision making for itself with a full consciousness, what is to lose and what is to gain. And is it worth it to carry on with the same behavior as before, or the beauty of the universe is so much that we sacrifice a few pieces of land to see the beauty of the lands of the universe? This is what this teaching of today was about, for those who didn't understand. This is not a dream, as now we see patches, breathing, and everything else. Now we start seeing the beauty of the technology. Now we start seeing the effect of the technology, and now we see how what it brings us. It brings us peace, it brings us comfort, it brings us health, it brings us food. Are we going to fight for nothing, or are we going to accept the nothing for peace of land? Because now we've seen it. You deliver it every week, little by little, the knowledge of the man is getting stacked up more than past 1,000 years in a few weeks or few months. I ask you to ask yourself one question, and whenever you give this to somebody, is the world peace worth it for all the wars to convert and change with a piece of copper? And that's all it is you're doing. You're playing with a piece of copper. The weapon of the new technology is its simplicity of its application and its implication. Thank you very much for today. We'll meet you on Tuesday afternoon for 1.5 hours as part of the normal teaching. And on Tuesday after 3 o'clock, we join Professor Zhu and the military and air forces or military and space, that these militaries will become part of the peace military, not the war, which is the act and the behavior of the nation of China. We thank you for being with us today, and I hope we'll learn more in the coming time. Thank you very much.
Very good. Thank you, Mr. Keshe. Thank you once again. Okay. That'll be the end of the 117th Knowledge Seekers Workshop for Thursday, June 9th, 2016. And once again, thank you everybody for attending. And we'll end the live stream now. Those who have questions left over can present them next week, perhaps.